chapters of the same book, just a different page. Niggas in the struggle all out to get paid, doing what we gotta do to avoid the rage. Avoid the cage, but you can't avoid the grave. Chapters of the same book, just a different page. Niggas in the struggle all out to get paid, doing what we gotta do to avoid the rage. Avoid the cage, but you can't avoid the grave. When you live by the sword, you die by the sword. I probably die in the vocal booth, spitting out raw. Die on stage, ripping down tours. Die from age, tricking out of town whores. Die cause I didn't have one in the pipe. Might go out like Raymond, went out on his bike. Die on the death mission, two texts bitten. No vest section from my chest missing. Die cause the jewels in my necklace glisten. In the V-Twizzy and a reckless volition. Die in the streets over something petty, cause a broke ass nigga tried to say I asked Betty. Die from a shot, from a cig or a Glock, from a kid on a block by sitting in a drop. Or die cause I was on, ain't see him coming. Too late, 8 shots got my body numbing. Die caught fucking his bitch in his bed. Die cause a nigga thought I snitched to the feds. Die with a knife 6 inches in my head. I could die on death row, sentenced to the chair. Die cause a nigga pulled his Roscoe out quicker. I was high on vodka, hydro, or malt liquor. Die cause I knew I should have laid that man. Die cause the cops tricked me to say that man. Die cause I hesitated to spray that man. Die cause I hesitated to pay that man. Die cause my man passed me an empty tool. Die cause I panicked, couldn't keep my cool. Die cause I mixed all them pills with Hennessy. Or die cause the niggas was jelly, envied me. Die trying to seal the fate of my enemy. I could go out from in case of mistaken identity. Or die cause the door wasn't open, it was locked. Die cause the floor was broken, it wouldn't pop. Die cause the nigga wasn't focused on the block. Die cause them niggas thought the coke was in the spot. Die cause another nigga said I said something. Die cause that newsy bitch said I did something. Die cause the nigga was trying to get a name. And die cause it was just my time to fill the flames. Might get sparked, might not feel no pain. Might go out like dark skin Jermaine. Take a couple shots to the heart, to the brain. Got all the dough, don't know the cost of the game. Young buck didn't wanna come off the chain. Couldn't handle the rock, got horsed in the game. I could catch a bad break like Big or Pop. I'd rather go out in the mash jig, make us a lot. Chapters of the same book, just a different page. Niggas of the struggle all out to get paid. Doing what we gotta do to avoid the raid. Avoid the cage, but you can't avoid the grave. Chapters of the same book, just a different page. Niggas in the struggle all out to get paid. Doing what we gotta do to avoid the raid. Avoid the cage, but you can't avoid the grave.
Whatever this delusion is that you guys will ever be able to compete with me, let go of it.
Salute, MobTube. How's everybody doing tonight? I have a feeling I look blue, but if I do, it's all there is to it. It's going to stay that way. What do we got, 93 people? All right. You know what I'm going to have to do, guys? I'm going to have to go through a bunch of videos and remove the music. Then YouTube will be happy with me again, you know? That's Facts B. Yo, yo, what up? What up? What up, B? Bronx, stop it. Dave, Bobby Berberian, Pat Travellino, Joe C, Antonino, Rolex and Race Cars. Let's see, Paul Atkinson, Scott L, Root Irish, Albaz. Scott L, 199. Thank you very much, bro. Jason Mike Sell, Casey Robinson, $10. I want to talk, threatening women and harassing my family like a coward. He's a sick individual, bro. He's a sick individual. There's no doubt about it. Like, he's really one of the creepier people on here. His obsession with me and everything, related to me, is I don't even know what to say. I mean, guys, again, this is why I say, this is entertainment for you guys, but do you understand how creepy this is? Being me sometimes, knowing that all these creeps are thinking about me night and day. I mean, there's a guy, this guy's in the UK or whatever. Can't get his mind off me. Cannot get his mind off me. It's nuts. Clojida, feared. Again, thank you, Casey Robinson. John DeLong, what's up, bro? OC, you're Benny Diova. FBS in chat, what's up? You know what I've been noticing? I would always see Angela leave Angel's chat at the exact same time FBS is scheduled to do a show. Things that make you go, Yeah, she's a big fan. She never misses an episode. I what's going on? I heard she's upset with me. I can't believe it. I mean, why would that be? Benny Diora, I think they're obsessed. She's a big fan. Show support, Angela, to your favorite YouTuber and send a few dollars. No, no, no. She can keep it. She can keep it. Mini 560, how the fuck are you? Yeah, that's right, Dexter Morgan. That's 100% true. You know, I'm not on point tonight. I'm trying to find it. There you go.
There's only one guy with a brand new futon, and it ain't FBS.
Good times. Mustache Pete, did I shout you out? You're Brian Bozak, Cecil Clanton. I don't know who I shouted out and who I didn't at this point, so I'm just going to cut it out now, you know? It's enough for the shout-outs. Sam, pay it forward. I didn't shout you out. Look at me. Here I go. I'm still going. ML, what up, Chris? Hope all is well with you, bro, from New Jersey. I love this show, brother. Well, thank you, ML, bro. Shout out to Jersey. I appreciate your support. But FBS, they love you. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, Sam, pay it forward. That's true. It is true. It is. If only I could be the cash cow for myself. Who's my cash cow? You know what I'm saying? I'm everybody else's cash cow. Who's mine? All right. No, and you shouldn't, Casey. You shouldn't. I think what we need is a help from one of our friends from the UK, you know, in this situation to maybe provide us with some info, you know, something like that. That's what I think. Ryguy86, Tony Pizza's the same way. I don't think he has made a show in 2 years without mentioning FBS. You're his boss. Yeah, I'm all there, all of them. I'm their boss, every one of them. Bruno, what's up, bro? I just mentioned you earlier. I feel like I haven't seen you in months. What is that? FBS on. I know what that is. Brian Bozak, FBS, I am pretty mad at you also. I haven't seen any returns on my investment yet. I thought we were partners in FBS Inc. We are. But you have to understand, I'm in the red right now. Okay, I am. I'm in the red. I'm not doing well. I will reimburse or, God, that's not a good word. I'll compensate you guys. You know, I'll pay your dividends on your investment. I will eventually, I promise. But it's been a horrible, horrible time for me. And I'm just not making any money. So, unfortunately, I have to put it off. You know? I think it might have been a mistake investing in me. So, what's going on? What is Angela trashing me or something? Hey, listen, I got to tell you the truth. I just don't care. Like, Angela, say whatever you want. I don't like you. I don't feel the need to talk about you every day. Every now and then I address you, but what can I say? Keep watching. Keep watching. That's all I have to say. Rusty's Trim. Maybe I'll let him in here in a minute and show you. FBS, I don't know how Angel's audience takes the one-hour worship of their Lord and Savior, John Gotti Sr. every night. It's so bizarre. Yeah, it is to me too, you know, but that's what she chooses to do on her show. What can I say? I mean, I don't know. I don't know. At least in her case, it's her father, you know? My father, it's the other people that worship these mobsters, and especially sometimes specific ones that that really baffle me. I know I did, Jesse Roth. I'm sorry. You'll get it. I promise. Brian Bozek, $5. Thank you. He said, help me get a return, people. Yes, the more money I make, the quicker I can pay out those dividends to my investors. You know? Yes, thank you, Jesse. Jesse is my Miss Can't Be Wrong for the night, I can see. FBS, I've been dealing with a few personal problems lately. Maybe I'll email you my number and get your advice on something I've been dealing with, bro. Too personal to say here. Nope, I understand. Yeah, email me for sure, bro. I'm sorry you're going through shit right now, man. I hope everything gets better. Steve Cutler, thank you. Yeah, I lost this one in my closet. Like, I just was going through my closet. I was like, ooh, look at that. I think I wore it once before with the black and taxi yellow Jordans, but I totally forgot about it. Mark Giglio, $9.99. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, thank you. Angels Moist. Oh, come on, Paul. Paul, you're going to get me in trouble over here. Ranger Fan 11. All right, bro. Sleep well, my friend. Oh, okay, Bruno. No, understood. You don't have to say no more on here. Then, yeah, you absolutely email me and I'll call you tomorrow if you'd like. I'd gladly like to talk to you about that, you know? So what do we got? 157. Yeah, my algorithm is shot. Hold on, let me see something. Oh, it's all right, Jesse Roth. It's okay. All right. Nah, Paul, it's all good, man. It's all good. What do I want to talk about tonight? That's a good question. What do I want to talk about? You know, I thought I had something in mind. I could have sworn I had something in mind. But I don't know. I didn't get to hear Tony Pizza's reaction to our little throwback earlier. You know, the video. Did anybody hear it? What'd he say? Maybe he didn't even address it, but I have a sneaking suspicion that he probably did. You know, I just have this feeling that Tony felt the need to address that. I was thinking about something earlier, though, like this Johnny Mac and Tony Pizza thing. And I can't tell you that it's not wildly entertaining to me. And I'll tell you the number one reason. Because we all knew it was coming eventually. Like, out of the two people, Tony Pizza and Johnny Mac, think about this. I want you to really think about this. Johnny Mac is the biggest backstabber. Oh, yeah. It's been proven. Tony Pizza can stay more loyal to somebody than Johnny Mac. And I want to put that into perspective. Tony Pizza can't stay loyal to damn near anyone. Okay. The fucking guy will, you know, Joe Candela just paid his rent for a month and he's like, fuck Joe Candela. You know, Mark Schumacher, I gave him thousands probably. And then I don't know what exactly happened, but he said, fuck Mark Schumacher. Sandra Luciano. Okay. She was his biggest cheerleader. She raised more money for that animal than anybody else that I could think of. And, you know, she got mad at him because he was saying some racist, you know, shit about, I don't know, Hispanics, whatever. And she, you know, walked away and he said, fuck Sandra Luciano. You know, it's like one after another, after another, after another. Yeah. So for Johnny Mac to be a bigger backstabber, I mean, that's got to tell you just how low he really is, you know? Holy shit. And Pizza's right. Pizza's absolutely right about the money. Like, Johnny Mac, he had a couple of reasons for getting back together with Pizza. And I'm talking about the first time months ago. His main reason was because he needs Pizza. He can't fight on his own. You know, he needed him, especially when it came to going after us. So he used Tony for that. But also, the money. You know, Johnny Mac knew if I could make friends with these Christopher George and all these people like that in the chat, then he would get a piece too. Johnny Mac knew that. And I'm going to tell you the truth. I am shocked that Tony Pizza was okay with that. You know what I'm saying? Because the things they've done to each other. And then, like, all of a sudden, some of Tony Pizza's money is going to Johnny Mac. I watched it with my own eyes. We saw a fucking email from Cash App that said that Tony Pizza sent Johnny Mac $50. Johnny Mac, with a thriving gem business, who doesn't need money, he just does this as a hobby, he needed a homeless man to send him $50. I mean, it just goes to show you, Tony Pizza was the better of the two as far as friendship. He really was. I mean, I can't believe I'm saying this, but it's 100% true. It's been proven. You know, it really has. Maybe I'll get back to that. Let me read some comments. Oh, he got one of his channels back? Okay, that won't last long. Maybe Pizza jumped in the lake after watching the video, metaphorically speaking, of course. Maybe. That would be nice. Yep. Pizza is the man. Love that cocksucker. Oh, okay. Paulie Walnuts. Pizza is the man. All right, Paulie, whatever you say, bro. Jesus. Oh, shit. Tony reacted by bitching about you giving him only $100 on your biggest night ever. First of all, it is not my biggest night ever. It was at the time, but I've had days where I think I had one night where I made like $1,400 between cash and super chats. That was my first huge night, without a doubt. But bro, I wasn't giving you money out of friendship. You deserve nothing from me. I was giving you what I thought, without doing an exact count, what I thought you were owed from the chat. That's it. You know, I was doing that. I was giving you what I thought was owed to you. I was not trying to be nice or do favors. I was not. That money fucking started coming 20 minutes or so after you were even on the fucking show. It had nothing to do with you, except for the few people, four or five, whatever it was, who said split this with Tony or give this to Tony. That's it. Everyone else was super chatting to me and Shanna. So no, he's not. Let's see. Tony spent a lot of time reminding viewers that the weekend is already here again, meaning it's time to pay up again. Yeah. He said that. I heard him earlier. This month is going fast. It is. I think it's going slow as a motherfucker. It's only the 8th. I mean, shit. Italian Mamba. We should get sponsors and get FBS versus Tony Pizza in a boxing match. Winner takes a cash prize. I'll bet my house on FBS winning by KO. I'll tell you what, I don't need any cash. It can all go to him. I'd be so excited about doing that. I swear. Give me a time and place. But again, you can't get sanctioned and stuff with my type of health. I mean, why can't we just meet in the street and fight? For fuck's sake, with all these organized things. Like, I'd rather just meet you in the street and fight you. You know? FBS Slob Tube made the news today. 600 pigs were rescued in an 8-acre sanctuary in Florida today. Wow. Good for them. Unfortunately, they didn't all, not the pigs, but, you know. Fuck that. You're the boss. You don't have to give anyone shit. No, I know, but you know how I am? Like, you know what I'm saying, bro. Like, I don't know, man. Like, it wasn't, like I said earlier, it wasn't for his sake. Like, it was the people who were giving me the money. Now, if somebody super chats me right now and says, give half of this to Jesse Roth, okay, and I don't give it to her, would any of you ever have any reason to trust me again? Would you even feel comfortable donating to me? Because you would feel like I robbed you of that money that was supposed to go to Jesse and that I robbed her by not giving it to her. You know? So, you know, I keep my eye on the ball. I don't give a fuck what Pizza thinks about me. It's the fucking thousands of people that were going to watch that video. And I think just under 6,000 people did watch that video, if I remember correctly. So, you know, it's about, first of all, it's about doing the right thing. Secondly, it's about optics. I mean, like, and it's about the fact that I like to keep my donors and, you know, and I'm not going to give any reason to say that I'm a thief or anything like that. I'm not going to give my enemies any ammo. I wouldn't rob from people who are super chatting to me or super chatting me, whatever. And if I did that, that's what I'd be doing. I'd be robbing them. What was that? I just get ran. Oh, it's the front door notification. The fucking cameras. Jesus Christ. Oh, my God. The fucking nonstop notifications from all the fucking cameras, I'm telling you. I mean, it's worth it, you know, but it's like every 2 seconds. Yeah, yeah, like that, it's the jacket. You know what I mean? If you give me something, I'm going to do what you want me to do with it. You know, so that's all. Jesse Roth, you keep my half FBS. I heard you're unemployed. This is true. I don't have a job. I live off Shanna. You know what I mean? I just hang out in the house, sit on the couch, watch movies, eat Cheetos. I'm all fat and stuff. You know? Very, very true. Did you send 20 to Tony that I sent? LOL. If you really wanted that to go to him, Paulie, I swear to God, I'll send it to him right now. I swear I would. I assumed that you were joking, but who knows? You want it to go to Tony? I'll send it to him right now. It'll pain me, Paulie, but I have to do it. I have to do it. Let me know. Ah, shit. So that's all he talked about, huh? Was the fucking $100. Leave it to him. He zooms past everything else. All the shit I said, all the stuff. All right, yeah, I just wanted to make sure, Paulie. You know, all that good stuff. And he just went for the money, of course. But you know, like you said in that video, he's not in it for the money. He's not in it for the money. I want to tell you about something else. First of all, I got an email. Well, I'm not even going to talk about that one yet. There's one, you know, I guess I had told a story that I had heard in an email or read from an email. And I actually, it turns out, told the story wrong. And then, you know, there's the news story was given to me. I don't know. But I'll get to that another time. Right now, I want to talk about Nick. You guys remember Nick from Tony Pizza? The guy that, you know, was supporting him also, and he turned on eventually. The guy that I was talking about earlier, he's the one I called the night I was looking for Tony Pizza when Tony was supposedly here. And he sent me an email. I'll just read you part of it. He said, LMAO, tonight's show brought back so many memories from the beginning of the madness. I still watch your show every night since first one. P.S. It was that I didn't have your number. I gave you mine, LOL, and said to call me back private, not knowing if you wanted to give me your number. So when I told the story about how I didn't have Nick's number and I told him to call me back, it was actually the other way around. I didn't give him my number. So I called him about Tony. I said, call him and I'll call you back in 15 minutes. So, you know, little correction there. But thank you, Nick. Drop the link? Certainly. Hold on. What the fuck did I just do? Let me get the link first of all. My wife's trying to get me to binge watch John Wick tonight. I've never seen any of them. I heard they're good, though, chat. Are they worth binge watching? Well, I've never seen them either, but you've heard my, you know, my preference when it comes to movies. If I remember correctly, that's like an action or fantasy or something movie, right? Like that's not anything grounded in reality. John Wick or all the John Wicks. You guys let me know. I just can't watch it like that. I can't, man. But we're going to watch a couple of movies tonight. I just don't know what they are yet. I'll tell you what, though. I watched a movie the other night called Tell. It was really actually very, very good. I think it's on Amazon Prime. Here he is. The man, the myth, the legend, the man who said, fuck you, Barstool Sports, Jeff Nadeau.
I just wanted to say one thing.
All right.
It's all about the numbers. That's what it comes down to.
Yes, yes. It's all about the numbers. Yep. In the beginning of that video I played earlier, if I would have played left the first.
Oh, yo, what the fuck?
Look at this.
Yo, what the fuck, bro?
Is that who I think it is?
I guess someone wants to say hello to you.
Yeah, I know who it is. Yeah. What's up, bro?
How you been, man?
Good. I've been trying to get a hold of you. That's how I've been. Yeah.
You called me?
I called you a couple times.
When? You got a new number?
Within the last few. You have my new number, right? I believe.
I must not know because I don't answer nobody's. Look, I'm in mob genre, bro. We can't answer calls that don't have you don't know who it is.
Yeah, well, yeah, it could be very dangerous. Now, I called you a couple of times, but I didn't hear nothing back. So I was like, all right, RJ doesn't like me anymore. It's all good.
No, bro, you think
I'm just fucking call? With you. No, I figured that maybe I didn't give you my new number, or maybe you didn't save it, and you just.
I can't answer no calls no more unless I know who it is, because you know I'm. You know.
We're actually starting a new show called The Two Horsemen.
Oh yeah, is that right?
That's what we're doing here.
How you been, bro? Everything's good.
What'd you say?
Everything's good with you, though.
Yeah, man, everything's good, bro. How you been?
I'm great, man. It's good to have it. Yeah, it's nice to get and chop it up with you again. I got to come on your show, so got to come on again.
I'm yeah, bro, you're welcome anytime.
So. Yeah, we all live so close. Me, you, and Jeff. We should get together and go have dinner.
We have to.
Yeah.
Maybe next week or something.
Yeah, we'll go have a cigar or something. So
yeah, we'll set something up for sure. So what are you guys doing?
Is that JJ? What's up, JJ?
JJ who? Oh, JJ's reviews. Yeah.
He's good money. He's cool.
Casey said RJ is a good guy. Yeah, what are you guys up to tonight? Just chilling?
We're just hanging out. He lives like 5 minutes from me. So he came over to see my house.
He actually moved even closer to where I live. Yeah. We're like literally a 5-minute drive. Yeah. So I popped
in. Really?
Yeah, so I just popped in to say what's up. And then we were doing some stuff online. And he said, oh, FBS is on. So, yeah.
Oh, that's what's up, man. Yeah, it's good to see both of you.
We were just talking. I said, yo, why don't you just pop over, man?
Yeah. So,
okay. Oh, that's cool, man. Yeah, that's good, man. Well, glad to see
you guys. I'm gonna hit you up and we'll go have we'll have lunch or something or whatever. We'll all get together, have a cigar, go to a cigar bar or something. Well, yeah.
We know he likes cigars.
Yeah.
Or we'll go to dinner or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, for sure. Listen, Jeff has my new number. So just, grab it from him.
But you got my number. Shoot me a text.
All right. Yeah. I'll do that. Yeah.
All right. We'll let you get back to your show, but we just wanted to pop in. By the way, that thing I told you about.
Yeah.
We were just perfecting the title. So it's going to be out soon.
Thank you. Really?
Yes.
All right, good.
All right, good to know. Guys.
Yo, bro, let me tell you something real quick. You know, I always give you your props. You got me over 1,000.
Yeah.
I'm always grateful for you, bro.
Oh, I know you are, man. I appreciate it, bro. I appreciate you remembering that and shouting me out all the time, and it means a lot to me.
Always appreciate you, brother.
Yeah, really like that. Same to you.
It's all about the numbers.
Take care.
All about the numbers. All right, bro.
All right, man. Take care.
See you guys.
Right. Talk to you guys soon. That's what's up, man. It's always good to see RJ. Always good, man. And Jeff. Jeff's doing his thing. Very proud of Jeff lately, you know? Yeah, it's good. The last time all three of us were on the screen together, I was doing a show about the mob. Probably the first show I ever did where I talked about the bad side. You know what I mean? About the shit they do to their communities and stuff. And I remember RJ was saying the opposite at first, but then sort of kind of agreed with me after I got into it a little bit. I remember that show. It was good. RJ was having internet issues. What do you mean, Rude Irish? You can't subscribe to his Patreon, or you can't, what, like Cash App? I don't know how Patreon works. Yeah, that was cool, man. Thank you guys for coming on. That was dope. Let me see. I knew as soon as I saw somebody running there with the hood up, I was like, yeah, that's RJ. Bro, I still don't know what's going on with Jamie Foxx, but from what I heard from Pizza, first of all, I don't believe what I heard from Pizza, but don't say it in the chat if it's, if it has anything to do with the C word, don't say it in the chat. John Wick is an assassin and there's some unrealistic aspect to it, but the action is real badass. I love John Wick. Yeah, man, usually when I see the word assassin, I move on. Maybe I'll check it out. I'll tell you what though. If I see one more motherfucking movie where it says mob boss, a mob boss does this, a mob boss does that, and then I click on the movie and it's some like lily white guy in the suburbs or something, like, come on, bro. What do you mean a mob boss? Where are there mob bosses like that? So, and when I say that, I don't mean like a Walter White type of guy or like a Russian mob guy. I mean, it'll just be like... Whoa. It'd be like a guy who's supposed to be a mafia boss, not just some mob. Like they pass him off to be a mafia boss. And his fucking last name is like vanilla as could be. It's not at all Italian, you know, and he's fucking, you know, it's just he's real proper. And it just it doesn't make sense. I can't fucking stand that. Since when did mob? Are we doing like some sort of woke thing with them, too? Like now mob bosses have to be all different colors and shit like that. I don't know. I don't know. But when the fuck did mafia bosses stop being Italian? Can somebody tell me? I'd like to know. I guess that's not allowed anymore. Is that stereotyping or something? Does that offend someone? I wouldn't doubt if it's that. I swear I wouldn't doubt if it's that. Like, but then again, I don't know. We don't bitch about shit like that. So who knows? I still didn't I didn't see it or hear it or whatever. You mean, is it his podcast or on his YouTube or both? No. This wasn't the first time, no. But the last time was real messed up. The video, the fucking audio was fucked up. RJ was on a crazy delay. So we were kind of talking all over each other. You know what I mean? Oh, yeah, but Pizza also said it's because of the CV. You know, I'm not even, don't even say the words. Fuck around and end up like stand-up guy. Six channels later, I'm still wondering why they took me down. Rolex and race cars. Nah, bro. Lancaster. And he worked, at least, you know, I don't know if he still does, but for the longest time, he worked in York City, where I'm from. You know what I mean? So, yeah, he's close, man. We're all very close to each other. I'm within 15 minutes of those two guys, probably less. So, yeah, we got to get together, man. It's just tough, you know? It's tough. Ah, Mikey Scars. How you doing, bro? Good to see you, man. You've never been in my chat before. That's awesome. Look at that. Special guest in the chat. And that's him. That's Mikey Scars. You guys can check it out, but that's a nice surprise. I appreciate you coming in here, Mikey. Mike's a good dude. We talked, you know, he's a good guy. He is. Three guests SoFlo had today, Teresa, the baby, and Code. Teresa, the baby, and Code. FBS, don't be jealous. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, I see what you're doing. Compared to the guests I have? Yeah, I know. I have Mikey Scars in here right now, and tomorrow he'll have Lefty, you know? JJ's review is William DeMeo for the part of a young Carlo Gambino because of his huge ass nose, not his acting, just saying. You mean okay, because he did play Carlo Gambino. Yeah, I see what you're saying about the mob boss thing. Yeah. No. But maybe soon. What is he, about 300 years old now? Everybody's saying what's up to Mikey. Expect Wanda Sykes to be the boss in the next mafia-based movie. She ticks three boxes. Oh, yeah. Anonymous Legion, I know. It's all about ticking those boxes. You know, it really is. It's fucking disgraceful. I told you, it's hard for me to even watch newer movies. When I say newer, I'm talking about... I would say it got really out of control in the last 3 years, but I could be wrong. If you guys know my story, then you know that 4 years ago, I was not exactly in any condition to judge anything. But yeah, it seems like anytime I turn on a movie from 2020, 2021, 2022, or 2023, right away you see the wokeness. You're like, oh, I see. Yeah, you don't fit for the star of this movie. And why the fuck did they have to throw all these other categories in here? You know, it's like a van with like a black girl, a Mexican girl, a lesbian, a gay guy, a Chinese chick. You know, it's like, what the fuck is going on here? That's a very diverse group of friends, you know? Very strange. But that's a prerequisite now. If you're going to make a movie, you better know that that's how it's going to have to be. Yep. Mustache Pete, now the mob guys are black and the gang members are white. A bunch of Devoto eating quote jokes. Yes, that's right. That's right. Oh, shit. Mikey Scar said, get RJ to take you to dinner. Listen, I'd like to take RJ to dinner. You know what I mean? Mikey, definitely. You know, all this time, I've known RJ probably at least a year and a half. Known him, you know, through phone calls and stuff like that. It's amazing we haven't gotten together yet. Me and Jeff just met in person for the first time, like, what, 2 months ago, 3 months ago, if that? It's strange how people could live so close and not get together. But you know me, guys, I'm always busy. And then when, you know, Shanna's not working, I like to be with Shanna. But I'm going to make a point of it to get together with those guys. Definitely. Thank you, Mikey. Thank you, man. That means a lot to me. It really does. I know RJ always has my back. And I heard you said something nice about me recently. So I appreciate that, too. I wish you guys the same. I know you're doing well, though. Very, very well. I congratulate you. I've always been a huge fan of my your show, Mikey Scars with RJ. Well, I'm going to tell you the truth. Well, I don't think Paulie Walnuts, I don't think Mikey would come on here. Of course, he's welcome. I'll drop the link, but I don't think Mikey would come on. And that goes into what I'm about to say. This is why I think they kind of caught lightning in a bottle. RJ and Mikey have their thing. You know, their thing. RJ and him have a great chemistry. They bounce off each other well. RJ always has questions ready for him, stuff like that. And Mikey hasn't been on anything else, which I think is a very smart choice. You know, he's just stuck with RJ. And that's good because you know how it goes. You go on too many shows, you kind of, I don't know, I won't say you lower your value, but some of the mystique is gone. And then it's like, oh, we see this person every day, you know, on this show and that show and this show and that show. So I understand why they do it the way they do it, 100%. Yeah, Carmine, listen, I had the wrong idea about him for a while. You know, we spoke about that. I apologized. I had some questions that I guess I needed answered, and he answered them for me. So, yeah, man, he's a good dude. And those guys, it is good. I don't listen to any of this mob shit anymore. But I'll listen to Jeff every now and then, and I listen to those guys. Jason Mikesell, I've watched every single mafia and mob-related movie there is to watch in the genre that was ever made since The Godfather. And trust me, there are very few very good authentic ones. Oh yeah, for sure, for sure. You know, another thing too is even though Jimmy Calandra and Mikey had their little thing for a while, I guess you call it a little beef, argument, whatever. I think they went back and forth, or I could be wrong, but I know Jimmy made a show about him once. When I spoke to Jimmy about Mikey, he said that everything Mikey says is 100% true. Like, Mikey was the guy, you know, in that area, in that neighborhood. You know, that's who everybody went to. He confirmed that everything Mikey says is true. So, yeah, Jesse, I knew that was going to be taken wrong. The guys dubbed me as Boob Tube. I didn't know about that. But what I said, and of course I meant you guys, the shows. When I said we are Mob Tube, like, did I put it up today? Where the hell is it? Right here. I kind of meant we, all of us, you know, the chat, everybody, you know, that's the way I saw it. But of course I put the other content creators like you, Casey, Redheaded Stepchild, Gunsmoke. You know, Guardian of the Night, I put you guys up there. Mikey is a walking mob encyclopedia. This is true. He is. Frank Fertilino, you're right. I got to stop popping up. No. You're Frank. Now, you know what I mean. I said this a while ago. You know what I mean? That. But you do the right thing. Like you said, you don't really talk about the mob. You come on and hang out and stuff. And honestly, most of the time, Aralata, like, I interviewed Arilada, and he was very, you know, he told me before, he doesn't want to get into great detail about his story. He only wants to, he'll answer basic questions, you know, but like the hit on Al Bruno, stuff like that. He didn't want to get too detailed about it. So I respected that. Howie, you, Anthony, you guys, when you come on here, or you, when you used to come on here, you basically just chopped it up with us. We made fun of people, broke some balls, you know, but it wasn't that much mob talk. So, Mikey, that sounds great, man. I'd be happy to do something definitely in the future. I interviewed RJ and Jeff recently. They were awesome. Oh, really? I'm not familiar with your channel. Did you do it for YouTube? Not sure. Let's see. Jason Mike Sell, I love listening to Mikey express his views about the history of what happened. A great counter to the narrative Sammy has set. I love the analytical, critical approach to it all. Yeah, he's good the way he recounts the stories and everything, and you know how detailed everything is. It's very interesting. I can't say it's not. Jason, Mikey Scars, I think I could speak for everyone when I said we would love if you did something with FPS. That would be awesome. Maybe they'll have me on their show at some point, you know. Let's see. Bruno, my top two worst, I'm sure that's supposed to say mob movies ever made, Godfather 3 and Travolta Gotti. I heard they sent for Travolta after that movie came out. Well, you know, Godfather 3, I'm going to tell you the honest to God truth. You know, I'm into damn near every good mafia movie that's ever come out. You know, everything, even like Popa Greenwich Village, stuff like that, Mean Streets, you know, and all the, you know, the 90s ones, you know, Donnie Brasco, Goodfellas, A Bronx Tale, shit like that. I also love like, and this isn't the mafia. Well, kind of is, but it's about an Irishman. Kill the Irishman. It's one of my favorite movies. I love it. And I could go on and you know, but I never got into The Godfathers, even without ever have been, ever having been part of that life. It never seemed realistic to me. Never. It just seemed like a romanticization. Did I say that right? Romanticization, something. Even I get one wrong every now and then. I'm well-spoken, but not that well. Yeah, it's not, I don't know. It seemed too, what's the word I'm looking for? Like, it was all a little too theatrical, and it was like an exaggerated version of what people imagine the mafia to be. You know what I mean? And it's, you know, we've learned ourselves. We didn't have to be part of it or be on the streets with these guys. Just from reading books and all that stuff, you know, that's not how it was. You know what I mean? So I never got into that. As far as the Travolta Gotti movie, that is without a doubt, the worst movie, not mafia movie, the worst movie of all time, of all fucking time. Terrible. Terrible. As far as mafia movies, of course, the worst. But I mean, I believe that's the only movie ever to get zero on Rotten Tomatoes. Zero freshness on Rotten Tomatoes. That fucking movie. I'll tell you what. A couple of weeks ago, I was looking for a movie. And I see Gotti on Amazon Prime. And I told you guys, I watched that once before. It was when it first came out, and I was heavily under the influence of cocaine and alcohol. I knew it sucked even then. But a couple of weeks ago, I put it on again, right? And as soon as the fucking movie started, when he's standing there by, you know, with the Verrazano behind him and all that shit, and he gives that little speech. I mean, first of all, I've never seen Travolta act that badly. I mean, it's the worst acting I've ever seen from him. He didn't even have the New York accent, all that stuff. I mean, but the whole fucking opening, you know, monologue, whatever the fuck it is, dialogue, whatever. When he's giving that little speech is fucking so fucking corny. I don't even know how to put it into words. I mean, it's the cheesiest thing I've ever fucking seen in a movie. And right then, you just want to take, like say it was a DVD you were watching. You just want to take the whole DVD player and throw it out a fucking window. You know what I mean? How fucking dare you, Travolta? You fucking sucker. How can you come on my fucking screen with this horseshit impression of John Gotti? It didn't even make sense. He's like, what? He's 4 inches, 5 inches taller than Gotti. I mean, you know, he would make those faces, the mean face, like the Willie Boy Johnson court scene where he made that. I can't even do it, that face. And he's looking around like a robot. Like, oh my God. This is the worst fucking thing to ever happen to cinema. Seriously. Terrible fucking movie. Whereas Gotti 96, I will always say, I think is the best mob movie of all time. Second only to maybe Goodfellas. That movie was perfect. I fucking loved that movie. I always will. I have that movie memorized. I know every line by heart. But that's Travolta shit. You know, and it's a shame because in 2011 or whatever it was when they first started talking about making it, they had like, I mean, it sounded like it was going to be amazing. It was going to be like Al Pacino, Joe Pesci, who else? There was a bunch of big names. I forget who it was that was supposed to play Angelo Ruggiero, Quack Quack. But it was, whoever it was, was that Pesci? I'm not sure, but the guy who they had play Quack Quack. I don't know who the fuck that guy is. But when he said, I said a lot of things that could get a lot of people in trouble, I was like, oh my God, how fucking dare you even do this to the memory of Quack Quack? The last thing anybody wants is for Quack Quack to be remembered that way. Like, meanwhile, we've heard the wiretaps and shit. I mean, what the fuck was he listening to when he was rehearsing for that role? And not the wiretap. What was he listening to? You know what I mean? Was he listening to some other bad actor recite that fucking line? Oh my God. Terrible fucking movie. Terrible. And it is known as that. You know what I mean? It is known as like the worst movie ever. Like, and I love it because it's fucking, it's the worst. Oh my God. Listen, everything about it is terrible. And you guys know how I feel about William DeMeo. I am not a fucking fan. I could go on and on. Horrible fucking movie. I thought that kid, I've seen him in other stuff. I can't remember his fucking name off the top of my head, but that kid who played Junior, that was a good choice. You know, but everybody else was cast wrong in that movie. Everybody else. Horrible casting. Terrible. All right, well, thank you, Jesse. No. Listen, anything I could do to help. Sit Down, a crime history podcast. They're good people. I'm a horrible individual. My guardian of the night, I would also like to thank you for your continued support for my channel, FBS. Very much appreciated, my friend. I got you. Well, thank you, guardian. Anything I could do. And if I ever miss a video, you know, if I don't share one right away, just hit me up an email. Yeah, Frank Fiordalino. I mean, those shows, bro, when it was all of us, when it was like you and Howie and Aralata and me and fucking Gunsmoke. One time Bill Cotolo even joined. I mean, Common Sense, you know, Mustache Pete, whoever. I mean, that shit was so much fun. Those are some of my most cherished shows, without a doubt. We didn't even have to talk about the mob. Mustache P, good for you, FBS. I like seeing this. Eat your heart out, haters. Ha ha. Peace out, everyone. Gonna go hang with my lady. Ciao. Oh, bro, have a good night. Have a good night with her. Yeah, yeah. It's good, man. It's good, you know. This was a pleasant surprise, you know, having RJ and Jeff on and then Mikey in the chat. Means a lot to me. Mike Jason Mike said, yeah, that would be super awesome if you did that FBS. I'd watch the hell out of it and donate for sure. Maybe. Chris, you ever see Oscar? Is it a movie? I don't think so. It sounds familiar, though. I don't think so. Sorry, I just got to that. I'm behind in the chat. I'm over here bullshitting. To be honest, I admit I was a Gravano fanboy, but after the first video Mikey and RJ did about the Gotti tapes, I dropped that fanboy crap and started looking more closely. I feel you, bro. I do. And I ain't going to lie. I love hearing Mikey and fucking RJ go after Sammy. Oh, it's fucking fantastic. You know me. That's like my, this beef shit is like my lifeblood. You know what I mean? It's like, I love it. I'm 4 years clean and sober, and this beef shit, I think, is my new drug. So, you know, seeing somebody like Mikey going at it with Sammy the Bull is fucking priceless. Yes, that's how I feel. Yep, exactly. It was all, The Godfather was all very sophisticated and professional, and it's like, listen, if you were ever in the streets at all, you know there's no crime group that's like that. You know what I'm saying? If they made it more realistic, it would have been an American Me situation. LOL, you know what happened. Oh, my God. So many fucking people got killed after that movie. So many people. Let me get down here. I'm way behind. Why don't the three of you do a live together? Oh, I'm all for that. Absolutely. As a matter of fact, I think there's something, there might be something in the works. I'm not sure. I haven't heard back yet. But yeah, I would love to do that. Definitely. We did one long time ago. But like I said, it was all screwed up. The video wasn't great. You know, the audio was all messed up. The way we were, me and Jeff and RJ were just kind of crushing each other when we talk over each other. If you don't wear earbuds and stuff, that happens. And RJ had a crazy delay, like a 3-second delay for whatever reason. I think his internet was slow and it just screwed it up. Richie B, the only scene I like, that movie with the guy played gas pipe and he was torturing the guy in the basement saying, come on, we just hanging out in the basement. I guess. Yeah. I see a lot of it I don't remember because, like I said, the only time I really watched it from beginning to end, I was so fucked up. You know what I mean? I probably had a fucking 8-ball in me, you know, who knows how much liquor. And even then, I'm looking at, I see 4 screens, and I'm like, this fucking movie sucks. To every screen I see, this movie sucks, this movie sucks, this movie sucks, this movie sucks, all the same movie. Yes, it does strong arm tactics. Yes. And it's not, you know, I don't believe it was ever like that in America. Oh, Sopranos. Yeah, man. You're only out here because of me. Yep. Fucking Joe Pesci Casino. Those panel shows were awesome. They were. The Mayo playing Sammy was the biggest joke in cinema history. I agree. My biggest problem with the Gotti 2018 movie is how it jumps all over the place. Not a big fan of movies that do that, but Gotti 2018 just makes a mess. Yeah, it does. I can hear John Gotti rolling over in his grave saying to Travolta, John Gotti, will sever your motherfucking head off if you produce this movie. Yeah, I'm surprised you didn't come back from the grave. Yeah, I saw that. Yeah, definitely. Definitely. I'm always down for that. I love RJ. Me and Jeff have been cool for a long time. I love them both, honestly. I would love to. Anytime. I'll hop on whatever, or they could come on here, you know what I mean, and just chop it up or talk about the mob or talk about whatever. What will happen first, Gravesend season 2 or the year 3000? Oh, the year 3000, without a doubt. Yeah. But which will happen first, Gravesend season 2 or Witsec Mafia? You know, you could also ask that too. All right, good night, Sam. Pay it forward. Yeah, he could. He could. But they nailed it in Gotti 96. Of course, it's too late for that, but you know, I think that the best casting for a future mob movie would be Michael Imperioli playing Joey Merlino. I mean, who else could they fucking possibly have play Joey Merlino? They look so much alike. And probably the same age. That would be dope. That would be an awesome movie. Awesome movie. Yeah, it is. It is. Well, yeah, that's what we get from Mikey now with all this stuff going on. Yeah. Plus, we see, this is one thing that's been proven. I've never heard anybody call Mikey out and say, you lied about this, you lied about that. But Sammy, just with this Tony Pizza thing alone, how many fucking times have we seen him lie? You know what I mean? Like, he lies constantly. He's fucking pathological. He's an old senile old man, you know? I fucking hate Sammy the Bull. I really do. Sammy, if you're listening, you suck. That's what I got to say to you. Not like you give a fuck who I am or what I'm saying, but I'm a guy with an opinion, and my opinion is that you fucking suck, Sammy. Yeah, Jeff, I know, bro. I know, it's the best part. You know, they didn't believe, this is so funny, that Vinnie Green asshole. I told a story once how, when I was a kid in New York, when all those flyers were up on trees and shit, Sammy the Rat, you know, with Sammy's head on a rat's body. I told a story how we took one home and we shot pellet guns at it in the basement, me and my dad. And of course, anything I say is outrageous. It's like, it can't possibly be true, according to people who hate me. And I remember Vinnie Green one time, oh, the best story is when he said him and his father shot BB guns in the basement at a picture of Sammy the Bull. Well, it's 100% true. We used to shoot pellet guns in the basement all the time, along with showing me every mafia movie under the sun since I was five. Okay, my dad thought it was cool to teach me good aim and how to shoot at things. Okay, it's almost like I was raised to be a criminal, you know? Anyway, we used to do it all the time. And yeah, one time we came across one of those. We usually used a regular target, you know, the standard fucking head and body and the fucking, you know, all that. But that time we used one of those. We put it right over a target. It was dope. And now that I hate Sammy the way I do, I'm glad. I'm glad. Now that memory is even more special to me. Chris Parks, the guy that played Quack Quack in the HBO Gotti movie, was perfect also. Vinny Pastore. Oh my God. Yeah, they look alike. It couldn't have been better casting for that. Yes, it was based on that real life character in The Sopranos. Yes. Godfather versus somewhat fairy tale. Yep. That's the way I always saw it. I never got into those movies. There was a hit out on Almost after that movie came out. Yeah. Danny Trejo said on Vlad TV that Eric Almost tried to avoid him for a long time after that movie. Danny Trejo knew top members of the Mexican Mafia and tried to piece things out, but people definitely died. A lot of people died. Yep. No, oh, yeah, I agree. Out of focus, Eddie, but he's a good actor, you know, so he can do that. Frank, I thought Oscar was comical. Oscar, you know, I got to look it up now because I probably have seen it. Oh, yeah, with Stallone. That one? Oh, yeah. No, I've seen that. Yeah, that was funny as fuck. That one, what does that remind me of? There was another one too, I thought, that was similar. It was like a spoof. Oh my God, what was it? There was a woman, oh my God. I don't remember now. But of course, the other one that I thought was fucking hilarious was Johnny Dangerously. I could watch that every movie, every day, that movie. Excellent. Oh, Jeff wants to come back on. All right. Yeah, definitely, Brian Miller. Get down here. Oh, yeah, Jesse Roth, without a doubt. I don't know who else they could have play him. Gunsmoke the Don. The cast of the Merlino movie would have to be woke, so Jerry Merlino would probably be portrayed by Eddie Murphy or something. Joey Merlino played by Terrence Howard. Yeah, who else? Mekhi Phifer plays Joey Merlino in 10th and Wolf. Oh, no, that horrible movie was already fucking made. Sorry. It'll be the 2023 10th and Wolf, you know? That's funny as fuck. Oh, shit. All the great Italian-American actors from that era, where they portrayed mob guys, they are all aging. This new young woke Z generation, there's no one to portray mobsters anymore. Well, that's why I cherish my fucking interview with Vincent Piazza, because I think, I'm telling you, I think he's going to be, you know, he's going to be legendary, a legendary Italian American actor, without a doubt. I think he already is with playing Lucky Luciano in Boardwalk. I almost forgot for a second there. Holy fuck! In Boardwalk Empire, and you know, The Wannabe. You know, I mean, you guys could think what you want about that movie, but and he didn't play a mobster in there. I just think it was great acting. Jersey Boys, he was a great in, and I think he's going to have some roles. He's definitely going to be typecast at some point, I think, as a mob guy. You know, Tulsa King, you know, I emailed him and congratulated him, but I was very disappointed that his part was so small in that. You know, I thought it was going to be, I thought he was going to be more of a star of it. Tony Pizza is the reason that Sammy killed his brother-in-law. That's the guy he caught banging the tallies by the jukebox. I saw Scarface when I was 3. Yeah, I saw it at a pretty young age, too. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Jeff, I'll bring you on right now. What's up, bro?
Yo, I was liking this chat. I like when we talk about this kind of stuff. Get on memory.
Yeah, me too. Huh?
I see, get on memory lane a little bit with these movies.
Yeah, what's your favorite mob movie, bro?
Bronx Tale.
Really?
Yeah, yeah, I love that movie.
See, I'm going to tell you the truth. My thoughts on that movie is it wasn't that much of a mafia movie. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I think if you say that, then, you know, I get that. It's more of like a drama, I guess. Yeah, I'll tell you, I watched. This would be an unpopular decision, but I watched The Irishman the other night again. I love that movie. I personally think it's unbelievable.
Well, I started watching it again either a week or two ago. I started, and I would just kind of listen to his background noise. It's definitely a great movie. Just very drawn out.
Long. The last 40 minutes are just so damn good, man. That's like such a great, like him getting older and stuff. I just love that part.
Well, the fact that they put every character in it, too. Skinny Razor, everybody. Yeah. You know what I mean? Yeah, fucking great movie, bro.
Yeah. Yeah. I think it was kind of wasted a bit. Like on this, I think it was out in the 90s. It probably would have been more popular, you know? But
yeah, yeah, definitely. Well, I don't know. Do you remember the hype behind that? Like it was like everybody couldn't wait for it to come out. Not just like mob historian type people, but everybody.
They put so much money into it and obviously the cast and people. My whole knock on it was they should have used they should have had a younger De Niro character. Like he should have been like a young actor. He shouldn't have played himself younger, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like beating up people and stuff was stupid.
Yeah, definitely. The makeup, you know, trying to make those guys look young.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, yeah, it was nuts. Mikey Scars, Johnny Dangerously. You never saw that, Mikey? Oh, my God. Look it up. It's with Michael Keaton. That movie is hilarious. I mean, of course, you know, it's a ridiculous movie, but that's the funny part about it.
Hey, Colodro's here. Cianello's in the building.
Yeah, he's right here. Bronx Tail here. There you go.
There he is. He's sitting on the stoop.
Yeah.
Sonny had five fingers, but he only used three.
Yeah. When they're standing there doing impressions of a Johnny Coffee. Was it Johnny Coffee Cakes? Was that his
Frankie
name?
Coffee
Cakes. Frankie Coffee Cakes.
I can't do coffee cake.
Yeah, didn't I have him say that on here when I interviewed him? I believe so.
Yeah, right? I think I actually asked you, could you have him say that?
And he Yeah.
And he did it.
I can't do coffee cake. Godfather 1 and 2 and Goodfellas in the Bronx Tale for me.
Yeah.
I would say my favorite, like I said, my two favorite mafia movies of all times are Goodfellas and Gotti, 96.
Yeah, I mean, I would, if you made me pick like mob movie, I love Gotti as well. You know, it's funny though. I watched that Gotti movie like a few weeks ago. You know, if you watch it now, you can notice there are a lot of like inaccuracies with it. Like some of the, like the casting's great, but some of it's like horrible. Like the Paul Castellano character is like awful, isn't it? It's like a big fat guy, remember?
In 96?
Yeah.
Oh my God. It didn't even make sense when he's you know, walking out of that pool with his fat ass, he's morbidly obese. It's like, this doesn't make sense. Paul Castellano was a tall, thin guy. You know,
one other thing that I noticed as well about the Gotti 96 version, the character that played Peter Gotti looks a lot like Gene Gotti and should have played Gene Gotti. And the character that played Gene Gotti should have played Peter Gotti. Like it was just,
I never thought about that.
Yeah. If you look at the character that plays Peter, I could see him playing Gene Gotti. Like at least that's what I thought, but that is a real good movie. Asante just says so good with it.
Oh, definitely. Well, me and Gunsmoke were yesterday. I don't know what the fuck, why we were doing this. We're on the phone and we're going back and forth with that last, you know, speech from John Gotti, you know, when he's starting his sentence and all that after he gets convicted, you know.
You think about the people in your life.
Bro, I was telling him, and I'll play it for you guys someday. One of my first mix CDs that was for sale in York City at Records.
You used that?
I used that speech, but I had just gotten sentenced because of a guy named, we called him Rozzy, who set me up in a controlled buy. So I kind of made it dedicated to him, the intro, and I used Cameron, What Means the World to You, with like that, you know, that sting beat, whatever. And I played the part. I don't remember how much of it, but when he said, "You're always going to wake up to the rat." You know, right. I had it. It was dope, bro. The intro to that mix CD was sick.
Well, you know, Arab had an artist, Dark Low. He played that whole, and I think Benny the Butcher as well, new rapper. He used that as well. Both those guys used that. A lot of people like that movie for like the gangster guys. They love that movie.
Yeah.
A lot of the rappers do.
Yeah, they do. Let me see something. Well, you know, let's get into that for a second. The rappers. How many rappers now have named themselves Gotti or something? Some mafia name. You know,
I was watching. Like, I was watching Growing Up Gotti. Maybe it's on Hulu. I was watching it randomly a couple months ago, and there was an episode where this kid, like this rapper kid, he like comes to the house, and they like make a whole thing about he has to ask Victoria if he could use the name Gotti. It's like it's super corny, but like even back then, people were using it.
Who was the rapper?
It was just some rapper from like Atlanta or something. I don't think he was popular or anything, but he wanted to call himself Gotti. So the sons were like talking to him and like invited him up. And Victoria like sat him down at dinner and like asked him like why he wanted to do that and like all this sort of thing.
It's crazy, right? How many Gottis are there? There was Irv Gotti. He had a brother. Yo Gotti.
I think there's a Y-U-N-G Gotti.
Yeah, and there's a Cheech Gotti or Cheech, some shit like that, I think. Probably. Somebody, Gunsmoke or somebody will put it in the chat. There's probably even more. You know what I mean?
There's a lot of, like, gangster rappers that have, like, gangsters' names.
Yeah. I remember Raekwon. Remember La Cosa Nostra. Like, there's so many references to the mafia and all that shit. And
they had Wu Gambinos, right? Steve Rifkin, who's the son of the Rifkin that runs like record labels and shit. They created like Def Jam and all that stuff. He did an interview with Vlad like a year ago. And he says that the Gambino, and I'd love to ask Michael about this. He claims that in the 90s, the Gambino crime family contacted Steve Rifkin about them using the name Wu Gambinos and like told them to pull the name. And they
really,
yeah, that was the interview I saw. He said they didn't do it, but he said the Gambino crime family contacted Steve Rifkin about it.
Wow.
I would think Michael, I mean, that was probably the time he was in the street. It was in the 90s, I want to say.
I'm not surprised. Well, wasn't there also a threat from somebody with, you know, who was with John Gotti to the directors or producers or whatever of Gotti 96 that if they put any portrayal of John Gotti cheating on his wife, that it was going to be fucking trouble?
I've never heard that. I mean, I know the family, they don't seem to like the movie. Like, I don't. I don't know that I've ever heard them comment on it. I think, you know, it's funny. I've talked to Kevin Connolly. I know him decently well. I met him through Barstool. He was on Entourage, and he actually was the director of that new Gotti film. Yeah. And he told me, essentially, it was very difficult dealing with them, like the family itself, about it.
Oh.
And I guess they were basically in control of it, and he made it sound like it was pretty difficult, but yeah, I would think, you know.
Wait a minute, you're telling me that the Gotti family made something difficult for someone?
I guess.
What's next? yeah, look, Strong Arm Tactics. Cool G Rap called himself Sam Giancana. Yeah, there was Capone from Capone and Noriega. Like, we really sat back and thought about it. There's so many. And I was right. There is some fucking Cheech Gotti. So there's Cheech Gotti, Yo Gotti. There's Irv Gotti and his brother, whatever fuck his name was.
Chris Gotti, I think his name was.
Yeah. There's Kevin Gates made a song called Gotti. I think Fat Joe referred to himself as John Gotti once back in the 90s in a song. Like, bro, there's so much. And when I first started on here and I did some hip hop DJ videos, some black dude was like, and you know me, I'll argue anything with anyone. He was like, oh, all you Italian dudes, you want to be like black guys. You become DJs, hip hop DJs and this and that. I was like, you really want to talk about that? You know what I mean? Like, seriously, you want to talk about people portraying other people's culture or stealing other people's culture? Let's talk about that.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. What about Childish Gambino?
Oh, yeah. There you go. There's another one. Yeah.
Somebody mentioned that. Also, do you ever hear that song Eminem does with Method Man and Together Now?
Oh, bro. It's been a long time. Yeah. Was that from a Funkmaster Flex mixtape?
Yeah.
Yeah,
Eminem references John Gotti in the song.
Oh, does he really?
He mentions John Gotti, yeah. A lot of John Gotti references over the years.
Yeah,
that's right. That's fact, B. That's a funny picture, by the way.
What do you say?
Only built for Cuban links was supposed to be called Wu Gambinos. But they have a song called Wu Gambinos as well.
Yeah, man. Does anybody know of that story I'm talking about?
Oh, yeah, it was Limp Bizkit. You're right. My fault. Not Eminem. Limp Bizkit.
Maybe Mikey knows. I swear to God, you guys can look that up. I don't know if it's online. It would have to be. But I heard that story several times that some of John Gotti's guys, now he was in prison, of course, called up the producers or director or whatever of that movie and said, if you guys show anything where John Gotti's with another woman or he's cheating on his wife, you know, there's going to be a fucking problem, something like that.
Who's the director of that movie? Robert Harmon. I'm trying to think who that is, what he was in. Because I don't really know him he wasn't really in much. I've never heard that. That's kind of interesting.
Yeah, I don't know. Tekashi 6ix9ine has a Gotti song.
Yeah, Gotti. Yeah, I remember that. Yeah,
that's real disrespectful for him to have a Gotti song. And it was that before or after?
It's before. And the funny thing is, it's a slow song. He's like talking about like women in it. It's like I don't know if you ever saw it. Yeah, he's like, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, that was way before his
cooperation.
Yeah. Yeah, I think.
But I can't tell you I've ever heard two fucking Tekashi 6ix9ine songs, honestly.
That song Gotti, take how many guesses and views it has.
Oh, I wouldn't doubt if it's 20 million.
544 million.
What?
Yeah.
It's crazy. What the fuck? Unbelievable.
I'd be pretty sick if you were like a Gotti family member, though. That.
Yeah. Is that right? They allowed the song to be called Woo Gambinos, but not, I'm sorry, but would not allow the album to have that name. Interesting.
Yeah, for sure.
It was in Raekwon's book.
Yeah, and then if nice. Also Rifkin mentioned it on that interview.
Oh, yeah. Well, let me see. Strong Arm Tactics. In the 90s, the two biggest names in the gangster world. Oh, yeah. No Ron Previty rappers. No. Peter Gotti probably threatened the wrong guy like he did with.
Have you ever seen, Chris, yeah. I wanted to ask you, you have you're on TikTok, KG. Have you ever seen like the obsession the Albanian rap community has with John A. Light?
I've heard about it.
Yeah,
but I've never seen it.
Like in Albania, he's like a hero in Albania. Like he's always on the news over there, and like they treat him like he's Mother Teresa.
Yeah,
it's really weird.
Oh, I'm sorry, I lost my train of thought. What were you talking about?
No, I'm saying in Albania, like
John. I'm looking at a comment. Oh yeah, I know, bro. I've always heard that the Albanians in general, they like he's like a man of honor to them. They look.
Yeah, they reference him like he's John Gotti. It's like I'm John A. Lee. Like
it's that song. You remember that fucking terrible song, John Alida?
Yeah, John. And he's like in the thing. He's like, you know, like
yeah. That was a horrible, corny video and stuff. But yeah, man, they love that dude, which is odd to me for a lot of different reasons. One, he pretended to be Italian. Two, he flipped. I mean, but who am
like,
I to?
He's
say,
literally man? Always on the news there. Like and he doesn't even speak Albanian. He just sits there and like, yeah, you know, I'm proud to be Albanian, you know?
Yeah. Well, I mean, whatever. Listen, the dude makes money and shit. What can I say?
That is a good name. Raekwon Lodrego.
Speaking of A-Light. So earlier on my show, I said that John A-Light addressed me when he was dressed in all pink and stuff. And I thought it was October. I said I wasn't sure. I looked it up. I put it in my community post. It was August 2nd of 2021. So I had only been on here a little over a month, you know? And Johnny,
wow.
Yeah.
Time flies, man. You're already coming up on 2 years. That's crazy.
Oh, bro. I can't. When I sit back and think about all the stuff that's taken place, it's almost too much to comprehend or to I don't know. I can't wrap my mind around all of it. Like I forget so many things. Like people will remind me about stuff, even interviews. And I'm like, oh my God, you're right. That was, you know what I mean? That was crazy.
Yeah. No, it's crazy how many different things have happened over the years. Jason Mike's like, the Albanian rap community is huge. There's a lot of famous Albanian rappers too. Action Bronson, Gashi, all sorts of, we're very entertaining. Yeah. A lot of
them. Give me 1 second, Jeff. I'll be right back.
Yeah, you got it. And Jason, you got to realize a lot of like BB Rex is Albanian, Dua Lipa's Albanian, Rita Ora's Albanian. The rap community is big as well, for sure. Absolutely Strong Arm Tactics. Albanians are huge in the UK.
Did someone say Dua Lipa?
No, I was just saying, like, there's a lot of celebrities that are Albanian that nobody really knew.
But you mentioned her, right?
Yeah, Dua, BB Rexha, Rita Ora.
I'm a big fan of hers.
Oh, Dua Lipa's beautiful, yeah, absolutely. Very, very attractive.
Yeah, did you ever hear the story where Miley Cyrus tried to, you know, and Dua Lipa told her, no way?
Try to get with her? Really?
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Really? I never knew. No, I never heard that.
Yeah.
I think she's probably pretty old-fashioned, probably. Most Albanians are pretty old-fashioned the way they do things. I
didn't even know she was Albanian until you said it.
Yeah, she's her parents are from Kosovo.
Interesting. Let me see. What do we got here? I want to change my name to Fiordalino Flow and become a female rapper.
It's actually a good name.
There's no Mikey Scars rapper yet, is there? Bro, no. There's so many. There's so many. Nothing would surprise me anymore. Like that since the early 90s.
I feel like I'm missing a big rapper that has a gangster name, and I'm not.
Me too. As a matter of fact, there's one I'm thinking of, and I swear, I think it was somebody who flipped, and I can't fucking remember who it was.
Wait, as a rapper? He had a rapper's name that flipped?
No. The rapper had a name of a mob guy who
had flipped. Really?
Yeah, and I can't fucking remember who it was, bro.
I'm like going through the list of rappers right now. I'm trying to figure out.
Because rappers, you know, they don't give a fuck about that. They just, you know, they just pick a name, whatever sounds dope, you know? And then besides, all that shit, let me tell you, if you want to get into it, like, bro, there's so many rappers. I have pictures of, I have pictures of posing with Chris Pacello in his clubs in Miami. It's like, you guys don't, you know, it's always like 50 Cent, you know, somebody who swears to be against all that shit. And stuff.
So one thing about 50 Cent that I've had an issue with over the last couple of years is he has pictures with Junior. He has pictures with, you ever hear those guys, those Puerto Rican or those Mexican guys that flipped on Chapo? They're mm-hmm. both rats. He did a podcast with them. And it's like, dude, I thought you.
Who did? Sorry, I'm looking at comments.
50 Cent.
Did. Oh, did he? Yeah, I'm not surprised. Yeah, it's like, I'm not surprised. Bro, there's so many pictures. All you got to do is Google Chris Pacello, and you're going to find pictures of him with 50, with Diddy, mm-hmm. with Rick Ross, with I'm trying to think of some other guys that are, you know, like.
They don't care.
Street guy type rappers. No, they don't give a fuck. You know what I mean?
Wow, really? There's a rapper from the Bronx called Joe Watts? I never knew. That's pretty interesting.
Is there really?
Spelled weird, he said. What, it's like W-A-T-T-Z or something?
Probably. Probably. Yeah.
Joey Watts or something. I feel like the most popular rapper would be Yo Gotti, right? He would be the most popular, I would think.
Yeah, then he'd have to be, yeah. But I swear, I swear we're leaving some Gotti's out.
Yeah.
I don't know. What do you think? Back to the movie thing, bro. I might have asked you this before. There's mixed reviews from different people I ask, but the movie Kill the Irishman. What'd you think about that?
I've never seen that.
What?
Yeah, I've never seen that. I've seen it on like Netflix and I've never watched it. I'm not sure why. Oh,
great fucking mob movie, bro.
Probably like the one I haven't seen, I don't think.
Oh my God, yeah, because it's, you know, it's based on the Cleveland Mafia, Lips Rosari and Jack Scalish, and yeah, of course Danny Green. But there's a lot of stuff about the Italian mob because that's who he was fighting with. Yeah, and I mean, you know, it was such an incredible time in Cleveland. It was fucking 1977, I think it was dubbed Bomb City. Like, I forget how many bombs, like 36 bombs in 3 years, some shit like that. You know what I mean? It was fucking.
I'm rewatching Boardwalk Empire right now, and I think when I'm done, I'll have to watch that finally.
Bro, I watched a few episodes so I could interview Vincent Piazza and give an opinion on his, you know, performance.
But it's a show that you have to be, like, it's not one of those, it's slow at times, but it's, I mean, there's so many great, like, just scenes and stuff. So you mentioned The Wannabe, so you mentioned a lot of people don't like it. I love The Wannabe.
Me too.
Yeah, I love that movie.
Now, here's a question, though. Between The Wannabe and Rob the Mob, which one would you pick?
Wannabe. I thought Rob the Mob was kind of corny. Like,
see, I would pick Rob the Mob, but you know why I think that? You know what I noticed? Whatever movie, which one did you see first?
The Wannabe.
There you go. I saw Rob the Mob first. Matter of fact, I think it was you that told me about The Wannabe. I think that's what it is. It's kind of like, you ever watch like a reality TV show and there's a different cast in season two and you just can't get with it?
Yep.
I think that's the same thing. Like I watched Rob the Mob first, so that was what I had in my head. You know what I mean? Even when I watched The Wannabe.
Well, I guess I didn't like the casting of Jimmy Darmody as, because he's in Boardwalk Empire. He plays the Uva character. I just thought Piazza looked like Thomas Uva. I thought the casting was really good. I thought, because you know how, like, you know, some of these gangster movies, they're like these, they have these like cool, like the Gotti new one, it's like super corny. You can tell it wasn't in New York. Like State Property had that problem years ago. State Property, you could tell, was not filmed in Philly, and I think it made it a shittier movie than it really was.
Yep. Definitely, I agree. Wasn't Wasn't fucking Gotti 2018 filmed in like Cincinnati or someplace like that?
Yeah, I think it was.
Yeah, I mean, I never got that shit.
Like, would it kill you to like go to like Astoria, Queens and do and just make it look somewhat normal?
Yeah, I know.
That's you weird, have Stacey right? Keach as Neil Delacroce. Stacey Keach, who the only thing he's known for is he did the American Greed opening like on TV. What else does Stacey Keach do? Like, I mean, he just has a good voice. That's about it.
Yeah. I agree. Let me see something. The actor who played Green just passed away. Shut up. Really? Yes, he was fucking young.
A year or two, or a week or two ago.
What?
Yeah, someone mentioned that to me on my Twitter account. I didn't know what to say because I'd never seen it.
Oh, bro, I'm telling you, watch that shit tonight, man. If you're going to be up, like, watch it. You'll love it. Yeah. I guarantee it. It was, I think it's one of the best mob movies I've ever seen. That's my opinion, honestly. Wow. Like, I That's fucking love praise. It. Man.
Wow.
Yeah, definitely. Ray Stevenson, he died?
Hmm.
Wow, May 21st, 2023. He just died.
Yeah.
Wow. What was he? He was a... He was born in 64, so Jesus Christ, young man. That's unbelievable.
That's a great movie.
What?
It's not Mafia, but it's Organized Crime. Gemini. American History X is an incredible movie.
Oh, man. Put your mouth on the fucking curb.
I have the... This is actually something I'm going to tell you on your show. It's exclusive. I interviewed yesterday... the individual that movie is based off of. I have him coming on my show.
Really?
Yep. He's from South Philly originally.
Oh, shit.
Guy called Frank Mink. And, you know, Chris, I thought of you when I interviewed him. He is really involved in the recovery community. I think you should have him come on. I talked to him more about his white supremacist days. Mm-hmm. But he has got such a great pulpit for like, addiction and stuff.
Who did he play in that?
He was the inspiration for Edward Norton's character.
Oh, Derek Vineyard.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
And yeah, he was like the main neo-Nazi skinhead on the East Coast at one point.
Is it true about his brother getting killed?
No, that was
just added. Okay.
Yeah, that was part of the film. But like a lot of the inspiration behind what they actually believed in and him going to prison and changing. He went to prison for like 4 years and he completely changed this whole thing. And you know what flipped the real kid? Prison. And when he came home, he went to South Philly, back to South Philly, walked into a corner store and looked up at the TV and saw the Oklahoma City bombing. And he told me straight up, he said, when I was like that, he said, our goal was to do exactly that. We wanted to be the guy driving a bomb somewhere. That was our goal. We wanted to hurt people. And he said, that could have been me, surely.
Did he know MRE?
I didn't ask.
Listen, first of all, I want to go back to this for a second.
This was a long time ago.
This is a great comment. My rap name is Angel Effing Gotti. Matty R, 999. The Outsiders, most overrated movie of all time, in my opinion. Just a phenomenal cast. Outside of that, it blew. Well, stay golden, Pony Boy. For real? I mean, I don't know. I thought it was a good movie. What do you think of that, bro?
I mean, the most overrated movie of all time. I mean, I could probably come up with several over it. I mean, like, if we're talking overrated, I mean, probably think The Irishman. I mean, people made that film out like it was going to be the next Godfather, right? And it wasn't, so.
Yeah, good point. But it was, I don't know if I'd say overrated because it was a great movie, so I don't know. Maybe it wasn't all it was expected to be, but. Yeah, Anonymous Legion, I'll check him out. Bert Kreischer, the machine.
Oh, the comedian.
Yeah, I've never seen that guy.
You ever hear Dana White talk about the mafia threatening him?
No, I actually haven't.
When he lived in Boston, he had a gym, and he said they used to come in and like try to shake him down, and that's one of the reasons he went to Vegas. I guess he like took a loan from them, and he just didn't pay it back and fled. and went to Vegas. That's what he says. Wow. He took a one from Kevin Weeks, who was Bulger's guy.
Yeah, yeah. Look at this, bro. Louis Castini, that was not the real Mikey Scars in the chat earlier. Bogus account FBS thought would bring in donations. Nadu sits on the panel of a scam artist, no conscience. I'm sure that many of my moderators checked that account. That was absolutely Mikey Scars. Do you agree? Yeah, there's no question.
RG was in my living room talking to Michael, and he was talking about it. He thought it was cool to be in the chat.
Yeah, yeah, you see what I'm saying? So, Lewis, nice try. But and this is another one. He said, I did that to get donations. Yeah. As a matter of fact, I would like you, Lewis, to go back, Louis, whatever, to go back to that time period during the show. I bet you won't even see me ask for donations. But I will now. Thanks for reminding me, Louis. If you guys wouldn't mind, please donate. I'd These appreciate people it very on much.
There never cease to amaze me. I had that Zio Lesso asshole in my chat earlier.
Really?
Yeah, do you talk about, like, first of all, this guy pretends to be this big shadowy gangster figure. Mm-hmm. I said to him, you know damn well, if you were a gangster, you wouldn't be on YouTube. You know gangsters don't talk the way you do. Like, why do these guys front and act like we can't see through this nonsense?
Like, it's, yeah, I don't know. It's a Vinnie Green all over again. It probably is Vinnie Green, the guy who played Vinnie Green on YouTube, you know?
Worst.
Yeah, absolutely. Did I shout out Stephen Cordell?
That's a funny
$10.
Joke. Very funny.
He said, what up? Thank you, Stephen. What?
Hey, Louie, why don't you join the show? Come on.
Yeah, Louie, I'll put the link in the chat for you, buddy, since you know so much.
A bogus account, FBS thought. Why is everything in caps but FBS? Notice that?
Yeah, listen, these people don't realize they're too stupid to understand. As soon as an account such as Mikey Scars comes into the chat, about 15 different moderators start checking to see if it's the real thing, just to make sure it's not a spoof account. So, yeah. Jesse or somebody would have texted me real quick. New beginnings with Shanna, my beautiful wife. Good to see you in here. I love you very much. I can't wait to watch some movies with you tonight and eat something good. Well, maybe I shouldn't have said it that way. That's going to be taken out of context. Food, some good food. Eat some good food.
He was talking so disgusting on his chat earlier.
Who?
They're going to say, he was talking so
disgusting. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Did you hear what he said to Shanna? Yeah. Angela is doing a live right now. Is she already
Oh, wait, started? There's Mikey Scars. Maybe it's the fake Mikey Scars here.
Yeah, let's see. Well, let me get down here. Guys, check. Yeah, I'll check right it's now. Him. I know, but just to be sure. Now I can't find him. Where'd he go? There he is. Yeah, Jesse Roth just said real. Yeah, 16,300 subscribers, 84 videos. Yeah, nice try, Louis.
Yeah, Louis, all you have to do is click on the profile and you can see if it's him.
Well, you have to have a wrench.
Oh, do
you? Okay. You have to have a wrench. Only the people with wrenches can do it. Because okay. I've tried that in other people's chats. I'm like, let me see if this person is really in here. And I can't.
You know, not to change the subject, but I'll ask. You mentioned you're going to eat like in a bit.
Mm-hmm.
You mentioned like earlier, like you're clearly losing weight. Is that you do that a lot? Like you eat late?
Well, this is the thing, bro. Everybody's got to remember, I don't eat late. I go to bed at 5 a.m.
Oh, okay. You go.
You know what I'm saying? So if I eat at midnight, it's the same as if I, you know, if I eat 8 o'clock or something, I went to sleep. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So, okay. You know, I do eat late in the night, but it's not late for me. I mean, I don't always stay up
till 4. You order something or?
I usually cook, bro. And believe it or not, you know what I usually eat?
What?
Ziti.
Oh, do you?
Yeah, ziti, some meatballs, garlic bread. Yeah, but I don't eat shit, bro. I eat like a little like 300 calorie Marie Callender's thing, like in the evening. That's all I eat, and then at night I'll eat whatever. And bro, today I was down to my lowest weight yet, down to 185.
Damn, so, good for you, man.
Thank you, bro. Yeah, man. So it's working. It's working. Like, and you know what it is, bro. You got to understand, I was always small and skinny. It's when I had this heart failure and they put me on all these medicines that I started putting on weight and fucking, getting bloated. And now that they found out I had the Hashimoto's disease, the hypothyroidism, they got me on the medicine for that and B12, prescription B12. So my metabolism is sped up. I'm just losing weight, bro. It's great. Right.
Damn, I never, I always wonder. I mean, I didn't know how late you went to bed, but.
Yeah, I go to bed, man. It's not always five. I exaggerate, but three, four, you know, something like that, which I got to stop doing. But I don't know if you're like me, Jeff. I can't just go to bed. Like, I have to wind down from whatever it is. Even when I work third shift, I could get home at 7:30 in the morning. I wasn't going to sleep till 11 o'clock, noon, something like that.
Yeah, I mean, I always, you know, watch TV for, you know, an hour and then I go to bed.
Yeah, that's how I am, man. I got to relax. I watch a movie, something, or even if I don't watch a movie, I'll put you know, some kind of background noise on and I'll fuck around on my phone. You know, I don't know if you're like me, but at any given minute, in any given day, I could come up with something I want to research. Like, oh yeah, I never looked that up. And I'll spend the next hour fucking researching.
I do that. I do that in my, yeah, I do it all the time when I'm in the shower or whatever. And then I spend time on reading on whatever I'm reading. Yeah, absolutely. I do that too.
Yeah. Look at Louis. The grift goes on. Louis, listen, you've been debunked, my friend. Please hop off of my dick. It's getting heavy. I got a fucking Cuban in Florida on my dick. I got a fucking woman who for some reason is obsessed with me named Angela on my dick. I got another pig in Patch Hog. She's actually a horse. She's on my dick. There's so many people on there that I just can't, I can't afford. I can't take the weight of another one such as yourself, Louis. So please hop off immediately. Thank you.
Hey, look at the private chat.
What do you mean? What you talked to me in Gunsmoke about earlier?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. But what do you mean? He must have.
I miss. He must have saw it.
Oh, I get what you're saying. Oh. Interesting. I didn't even know it was already up. When did you put it up?
A while ago.
Oh, I didn't know.
And then I pulled it off. I don't know what happened. Whatever.
You did?
Yeah. What? I wanted to fix something on it.
Okay. Mikey Scar said I'm a Gemini, so at least two of me. There you go. Let me see.
Who's hotter, Shakira, J-Lo? J-Lo.
Yeah. Well, I don't know what Shakira looks like now, but that was my dream girl, bro. So I don't know. I might have to go with Shakira. If she still looks like she did when she made She-Wolf, and Hips Don't Lie, I'm going to go with Shakira. You know she's tiny, right? Shakira's like 5 feet tall.
I said I like that because I'm not the tallest guy in the world. So.
Yeah, me neither. If you stand me on top of Jeff Nadeau, we're actually only 5'7".
Don't say that.
No. Oh, okay, I got you. I'm looking at the private chat. Let me see. No, yeah, tomorrow they'll be like, oh, see, they're each under 3 feet tall. Cecilia, the
I'm really not that short. Promise.
Yeah, what is this? Yeah, I already forgot something. Sicilian, that code is a dickhead from way back. Code? What are you talking about? The Louis guy or actually code? Oh, look, a lot of people said Shakira. Look at this. I think there's more fucking Shakira votes, bro. Probably because J-Lo is fucking, what is she now, about 55, something like that?
She looks like she's 30, though.
I know. I saw that scene from that movie where she was a stripper.
Can I answer Rude Irish with this
question? Absolutely.
Steven Shripa and Michael Imperioli.
Louis Eppolito and Steven Caracappa. Yeah. Oh, definitely.
I think he could play Merlino, like you said. I think he could also play Steven Caracappa.
Yeah, I agree. I'm trying to think for Louis Eppolito, though. There might be someone else. I mean,
I think Shripa could be. He's pretty hefty. They have good chemistry, you know?
Yeah, that would actually probably be perfect. because I don't even think Vinny Pastore would work. So I would have to say, yeah, that's actually, that's a good call. Definitely. Let me see.
Who would play Anthony Casso in that?
Anthony Casso. Oh, fuck. I have no idea, bro. I'd have to think about it.
Sebastian Maniscalco.
That might work. Honestly, it might work. And he could actually act. The little fucker.
I thought he was good as Joey Gallo.
The Irishman. Yeah, definitely. Mikey Scars, what do you mean Synthroid? What, as far as a medication? Or it's Levia. I'm not sure if that's what you're talking about exactly.
Paulie Wanis says Lizzo is so hot. Like bigger women, huh?
Let me see.
Yeah, Stephen Graham's a great
actor. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Mikey Scars, yep. It's levothyroxine, whatever. That's what, you know, I get the generic shit, whatever. But yes. Yeah, I didn't know that was the brand name. Absolutely. That's what I take. Yep. I think I take 50 a day or something, 50 milligrams. You have that too, Mikey? Shakira's still hot as fucking ever at 60. And it's 6'3". Jesus. I love her tiny ass. You 6'3". Oh, you're 6'3". Okay. Thank God I'm snipped.
Yeah. Well, Brian Miller says John Stamos as gas pipe. Yeah, I don't know about that.
John Stamos? No. Let's really think about it for a second. Hold on. Because you know there's probably a bunch of even Italian actors that we're not thinking of.
Bobby Cannavale, someone's saying. He played Skinny Razor in Irishman.
He could. Yeah, if you know. Yeah, he could. For Louis Eppolito? No, for Gaspar. Yeah, that's possible. Yeah, definitely. You know the first movie I remember seeing him in, I think? Nah, it wasn't the first because I had known him. You ever see him in that movie with the little guy? The fuck was it called? That certainly wasn't the first movie I ever saw him.
Who were you talking about? Him.
Bobby Cannavale.
Well, he was in Oz many years ago.
Yeah, yeah, but no, you remember the movie with the fucking, what's the little guy's name? The midget.
Danny DeVito?
No. The guy, not Vern Troyer. What the fuck is the guy's name? Somebody in here will get it. It was a really good movie with him.
I'm not sure.
Let me see.
I remember Cannavale was in Oz, though. He was like a gay club owner in Oz.
Vincent Piazza could play Casso if you put some weight on. Yeah, he could. That came to me at first, but it's the age thing. They'd have to definitely, you know.
Jane Creek says William DeMeo is fat Tony Salerno.
Oh, my God, please.
Look at Matty R. Super Chat. That's pretty cool.
Sebastian Maniscalco has a new movie where Robert De Niro as his father?
Yeah, I saw that.
Nicholas Torturo is from New York, too. He'd be great as Casso. He actually, you know, I fucking hated him as Sammy the Bull. I thought that was terrible.
Yeah, I hate that movie.
But I could see him playing Casso. He's a little guy, but still, I could see him playing Casso. But I thought he was horrible as Sammy the Bull.
Gunsmoke loves that Witness to the Mob.
I know. He's the only person I've ever met who thinks that's a good movie.
I don't get it.
Fucking terrible. Wasn't that Lorraine Bracco as Diane Jackalone and... Wasn't that a horrible fucking movie?
Terrible. No, she was in a different movie about the mob. She played Diane.
But still, though, because what was it? What's his name? Played that guy that Gunsmoke's a fan of, played Gotti, the worst Gotti.
Tom Sizemore.
Yeah. With the exception of Travolta, he was the worst Gotti I ever saw.
What do you think? One.
No New York accent, no nothing.
Someone says Joe D'Onofrio is gas pipe. He's kind of crazy a bit. I could see that.
He is good at playing a little evil Italian mob villain, definitely. But
that's a funny comment right there, the super chat.
Rosie O'Donnell starring as Chip Mayhew. That's funny as fuck. Thank you, Mattio.
Getting Gotti. That's right. Good call. That's facts, B. Where'd FBS go? It's only me here. My hair looks wavy right now. Look at my hair. My hair looks wavy as hell right now.
That's because you go to sleep wearing a do-rag.
Yeah, I should get waves, man. I should ask my barber tomorrow. Yo, can you give me waves?
Who is that actor that played young Tommy DeSimone in Goodfellas as Casso? Yeah, that's...
That was Joe D'Onofrio.
Yeah, I interviewed him, yeah. It doesn't matter, Gunsmoke. The movie with her as Diane Jack alone sucked, and so did Witness to the Mob.
Yeah, I'm not debating him, Frank. There's nothing to say about it. He did what he did, and it is what it is.
What are we talking about?
Frank Fiordalino says, "Hey Jeff, John Alight just popped me a call and said he wants to debate you right now." About what? The video I did on him was very kind.
Wait a minute, he wants to come on here and debate you right now?
About what? I was very nice about it. He got it so, he's so mad about that video. I don't know why. He says I don't talk good about the Gottis. I talk good about the Gottis. That's crazy. I think I'm pretty fair.
I'm thinking this over now. Let me see. So let me get this straight. Frank Fiordalino.
He wants to come on. Let me hear his voicemail. Hold on a sec. I'll be right back.
All right. What do you guys think? Alight was never on this show. What do you think? Just for the purpose of debating the do, I will sit back and shut up. I won't say a word. He's driving. All right. But if he wants to do it, okay. What do you guys think? One in the chat if you want to see Alight, I'm sorry, debate Jeff on this show right now. This would be crazy. It would. Let's go, long overdue. Frank, drop me the link. All right. Everybody's saying one. Let me see what Jeff says, because I won't sandbag him. You know what I mean? I did that one time, and I felt terrible afterwards. Cookie Puss coming up. One Cookie Puss. Now let's get Mikey to debate Alight. Are they enemies? Are they enemies, Bud Rob?
I don't know why he's so mad about this video.
Do you want to debate him on here?
If he wants to, he can come on. It's your show. Whatever he wants to do. I don't know what he would say to me. He's saying a bunch of shit. Like, he's mad. He says, I have no balls. I'm in the Gotti camp. You know, it's all the same shit. I don't think it would be a debate, but he can come on. Whatever he wants to do.
All right. Just for entertainment purposes. Yeah, I mean, you almost can't turn it down. Frank, I think saying he just wants to come on to give his position. I don't know. Let's see what happens.
I mean, again, the video I did was very nice compared to most. Like, I don't know what he's like. I really don't know why he's so annoyed and why he's left me these voicemails. I don't know why.
Well, listen, this, I'm not going to front. If Alight wants to come on strictly to debate you, I don't give a fuck what anybody says. I'm not turning that down. That's, you know, it's YouTube gold. It would be phenomenal. Well, let's see. Let's see if he does. I mean, look at Gunsmoke the Don. This is going to be fucking awesome. Let's see.
Tell him to come on.
Let's see what happens. I won't, Alight, I won't say a word. I'll sit here and just let you guys do it. You know me. You know me. When there's good shit going on, I shut the fuck up.
I'm probably the most nice to him of any of these people. But I just will not put certain things out that I can't verify. Sorry.
All right. Well, let's see. John Alight would be a good debate with Jeff. I think it would be phenomenal. Because I already can tell how it's going to go, because Jeff won't take no bullshit.
Well, he'll probably just scream over me, but I don't
know. I don't think he's coming on anyway.
I can call him.
Frank said call him. All right. Well, even if you put him on fucking
Let me call him and see what's up. Hang on a second.
That'd be even better. Put him on speaker. Well, I know for you guys.
Go straight to voicemail.
Oh, go straight to voicemail. All right. Well, I don't know. I'm looking. Nobody's back here. Like when DiBella came on.
He belittled me and I said, why am I? I'm on YouTube begging for money and stuff.
Who?
Alight.
Oh. I don't even see you ask for money. But I'm going to ask for money right now. 227 of you. Look at the fucking classic moments taking place in this show right now. I think I made $30. How dare you? Actually, I made 35. That's fucking horrible.
Hey, Gunsmoke, jump on the show, dude.
Oh, Gunsmoke wouldn't pass up an opportunity. He wouldn't miss this. Grab the link, Gunsmoke. Frank, if you want. A-Light, grab the link. This will be MobTube history. What happened? I don't understand. Frank said he wanted to debate you. I said, does he want to come on this show right now and debate him? He said, yes. And now I guess that's... I'm dropping the link again. Jeff doesn't want to platform anything he can't confirm. Would be good content tonight. Yeah, I mean, it would be.
No, the original thing is, he's mad because I said John Burke was like a real killer, and he doesn't agree with that, so he's mad about it.
But he sent John Burke to kill people, according to him.
Like, I don't have a beef with him. He sent me like a crazy voicemail, and like, now he's pissed off again.
Well, let's see. Thank you,
Brother Rob. I appreciate that, buddy.
Gunsmoke the Don. What? You can't come on this show unless fucking A-Light does now? What the fuck?
Shit starter Gunsmoke. Come on, you little prick.
You believe this shit? How fucking dare you?
The mob is.
A minute ago, it was all good. Now it's like, oh, well, maybe A-Light won't come on, so Gunsmoke ain't joining. Opportunist. Son of a bitch. Bud Rob. Nadu, I'll admit you've come a long way from the first time I watched you over a year ago. You have class, bro. That's hard to find in this genre, it seems.
Thank you,
Peter. Yes, I agree it is. Sammy grabbed the link. What would happen right now if all of a sudden A-Light and Sammy and Mikey Scars all came on at the same time?
That would be hilarious. And Mikey Scars came on.
Yeah. Ridge, 1999. This should be good. Jeff gives no fucks. Respect. No, and thank you, Ridge, first of all. But no, I could see Jeff digging in his ass a little bit.
Damn, Jason Mike said, you said some of my content was corny. I would love to know what that is. I'm curious. I'm always curious how I can improve.
He said what?
He said, Jeff has grown on me, to be honest. I thought some of his content was corny early on, but definitely, like Bud Rob said, has improved. I'm curious what you think. That's interesting. I would love to know what you mean.
I don't know.
Someone says,
I guess it was a compliment, though.
Someone says, pay me $500. I'll make Sammy grab the link.
Well, that's Tony Pizza right there. That's Poop Finger McCarthy Maltese Mauler.
Okay.
So if anybody can do it, he can. They're best friends, Tony Pizza and Sammy. Okay.
Nice.
Get Franzis on here to tell you. I did 8 years on the 10.
Let me hear you say it, Sammy.
Yeah.
That's funny. That's so funny. Let me hear you say it, Sammy.
Yeah.
He's going to... Frank Fiorellino.
There we go. Hello?
Hello.
This is John?
Yeah, this is... Who's this?
This is FBS, Fat Bald Sicilian. No, I got Jeff Nadu on here. I heard you wanted to debate.
Oh, yeah. I want to debate him for sure.
Hey, John.
I got my buddy on the phone, too, that grew up with him. So, yeah, I definitely.
John.
Wait. Let me take Mike because he can't hear you. Hold on.
No, it's all right.
All right, there you go. Now he can hear you. Go ahead.
Hey, John.
Yeah, go ahead.
So let me ask you, I thought the video I did was quite gracious on you around a month ago. You called me. What was your issue with it?
Let me tell you something. You got fired from that.
No, I didn't. I quit.
You got fired because I did a show with them. I did a show with the Boston.
Okay. I got fired.
They don't like you. None of them. They said that you're terrible. That's why they fired you. You're a liar. Okay. So did you get fired?
No.
Did he get slapped Philly for the same reason?
There's a video.
Are you the same guy that was 500 pounds and grew up with my friend Mikey?
But I'm also now 211 pounds.
Do I know what I'm talking about? Did Howie and Frankie to give you a lot of things, told you was truth, and you still lied?
John, I didn't lie, though.
But oh, there you go.
For a guy that goes on these shows and begs for a couple pennies because you're broke. You got fired because you keep getting caught in your bullshit.
Yep, I got fired, even though we know it's not.
hounded me to do a show with you, and I don't want to be bothered with you, to be honest with you.
No.
Because I knew what you were. You're a clown that's once back like you know something about the street.
Fair enough.
You're a guy that can't get a job. That's why you're doing what you're doing. And then you're going in your bed like you're homeless for a couple of bucks from a couple of people. Right. So really, I don't know why I'm wasting my time with you, but I'm going to tell you.
I don't either.
I was desperate. Listen, I don't wake up in the morning to think about you, but every morning you wake up to think about me.
Here you are calling in and making an effort.
You what?
You don't know what you're talking about. Just do your thing. I'll do mine, all right?
Yeah, what do you keep talking about me for if you're going to do your thing?
I did a show on you a month ago.
Hey, I haven't done a show since. I want to make a special show about you because I know a lot about you. I can talk about. First, you're not Albanian. Stop telling people you're Albanian.
What you got to do?
You're not a fighter, so stop telling people you're a fighter. You're a joke. Don't embarrass the Albanian nationality.
The owner of the company literally said I quit.
What?
How dumb is it? Is this guy listening to anything?
He said the owner of the company said he quit.
It was on the New York Post.
You could quit all you want. They were tossing you. You can say you could change anything you want. You got fired. You get thrown out twice, actually.
Okay.
Stop your bullshit. You can't even get a job. You're a clown.
Yeah. You're right.
You're doing. You're penniless. You're living in a one-bedroom studio.
Yep, one-bedroom studio. You're right.
Listen, were you the same guy that just got slapped in Philly? Am I right about that, too?
And I've talked about that very publicly.
You're very public. How about the last time you got slapped? You talk about that, too? You're just another guy who's a coward behind a fucking keyboard. Go do your shows, and then you got nothing to do with me. But leave me alone. What do you keep bothering me for?
It sounds good.
Did Frankie and Howie talk to you? Did Frankie and Howie talk to you? Did he purposely didn't want to talk about?
And if you listen, what? If you listen to the show, you would hear that I said a lot of things that they heard.
Oh, you're not a journalist. You're a clown.
Okay. Why are we doing this? Okay. Fair enough.
Listen. You're a desperate, dumb kid that got no life, and this is what you do. So do yourself a favor. Do whatever you're doing, and just stop talking about me to try to
John, first of all, let me explain. I did a video a month ago and haven't mentioned it since.
I have to say to you, when you got to keep using my name to get popular.
This is what this guy does.
There's something wrong with you because I don't wake up in the morning and think about you, but you think about me for some reason.
But you're the one calling in trying to talk to me, though.
I don't know what you do, but I really don't care. Okay. So just stop talking about me. That's all.
Sounds good. Have a good night, man. All right.
Go beg people for money, and that's it.
Don't chase them off.
Sounds good. He doesn't want to hear. He doesn't want to listen to me.
Listen, you want to bullshit. What I gave you paperwork. Why don't you go read it? Why don't you go talk to somebody who was in law enforcement? But you won't. Why don't you go talk to
John? I literally quoted Phil Spallo. I quoted him.
He told you you're full of shit. Both of them called you out. Both guys called you out.
Go ahead, Jeff.
Go ahead, ask them again.
Hold on. Let Jeff speak.
Full of shit.
Jeff, go
ahead. Told you. But you didn't want to hear nobody because you're full of shit. You got an agenda, and that's it. Just say that.
So what's my agenda?
You want to be on CNN.
What's my agenda, though?
He said you want to be on CNN. That's your goal? I don't think I don't
say that. What's my
why don't you guys just bury the hatchet and forget?
Yeah, I think he really doesn't like you, Jeff, because you're Albanian. And he figures you're supposed to
what's
be on
the
his
agenda?
Side.
I want to know what my agenda is.
What happened? What, John, why are you pissed off, John? Let him know.
He doesn't even know a thing about our culture.
What's my agenda, though, John?
He acts like a mutt.
What's my agenda, though?
Your agenda is to get popular for me. That's your agenda. You know, different than what's his name used to do? The other guy.
Wait, so you're saying I'm on the payroll of the Gaudis? Is that what you're trying to say?
Why would I even bring them up? Because
you said that to me. You said it to me multiple times, John.
Well, listen, buddy, I'm 10 steps ahead of you. Don't try to throw names and try to make yourself popular.
Listen,
if you got something to do, go do some study and be a journalist. But you're not a journalist. But you're just a clown kid.
Fair enough.
Okay,
no problem.
If you want a baseball hat, I'll send you a baseball hat. You can go on the corner in the city and ask for money in a hat.
Yep, that sounds good.
You want to embarrass yourself, You're not embarrassed yourself.
John, I'm one of those guys. Tony John, Pizza.
John, I do 10 times the amount of views you do. So let's not talk about it.
Listen, I really don't care what you say. Yeah, you're a really popular guy. Listen, you sound like a little 10-year-old. I do 10 more views than me. Views about what?
I beg for money.
Where'd you grow up? Did you know something about the street?
I've said that many times, though. What are you talking about? I don't pretend to be nothing. What are you talking about? You're talking stupid.
That's for punk, big mouth behind a computer that lies.
John, I've asked you to come. I asked you to come to the company.
You didn't want to hear from Howie. You didn't want to read any of the paperwork.
I had him vote on my show multiple times.
You don't want to read anything that Bonnie went on said. You don't. So who are you bullshitting?
Okay, fair enough, John.
He said he had Howie and Frank on his show a couple of times.
Yeah, he has. See, their beef is, if I'm correct, because I heard this the second time, third time. I don't know. He was supposed to be on Jeff's show one time, right, Jeff? What happened? Explain. Because you guys are going back and forth, but you're not explaining why you guys have had this beef. You were talking at one time, weren't you?
We're having a beef because I put a video out about John's life. I thought I was pretty gracious to him. He called me, left this blistering voicemail threatening me, telling me to sucking his cock, all this stuff. And he's mad. He said I didn't do a good job with the video. I lied on this.
Because he got fired from Boston. He's putting on blast. That's why.
Who the fuck is that?
Who is that?
That wasn't me.
Who the fuck is that guy?
But this is actually the third time I heard about it. And I knew you guys were supposed to have a show, and then you guys didn't end up having a show. And then the second time I heard from John, he was pretty heated. And you guys didn't really tell me about it. And at the time, I was like, wasn't my thing. But I didn't know what was said. And now it rose again. He said he's pissed off about something on Instagram lately. That's what he told me today.
Instagram.
Frank, you know the truth. Howie knows. It doesn't really matter.
About what? Yeah, we always said it. I think everybody on the panel knew. You know, back in the day, you did what you had to do. Everybody knew that. I'm not saying something that I've seen it off air. People have it, but they don't deny that. I don't understand why you guys didn't do the show. It was supposed to be a kind of a debate anyway. I didn't know what it was about, and you never did it. Who backed out on it?
Who was that? Who was the other guy?
Who backed out on the? I don't know. Who backed out on the show?
On it, and he went after the phone. He was hiding under the bed, and I said, "What are you kidding me?" And then he begged me back on the phone. Hey, is that rude, Jeff? Did you beg me to come back on for a couple of months? And I kept telling you I'm busy.
No,
is that true?
Yeah, I canceled, and then I asked you to come back on again. I'll have you on tomorrow if you want, John. What did you want?
All right, then here we go. We solved it. Go on.
Here's the thing. If it's going to be like this, I want to have a conversation. I don't.
Oh no, dude, you're not bad at what you do, Jeff. We all know that.
Some random guy talking. Like,
let me just ask real quick, John. What is it exactly Jeff did to make you mad to begin with that you left the voicemail?
Because he hung up the phone afterwards, and he said, we're going to start the show in 10 minutes. And never fucking started the show. And just never
No, happened. John. I tried
to find out why he went after the phone. He went after the phone. Then he started calling me day and night, begging me to come back.
John, I did a video on you, and you left me a voicemail. What's your beef?
Stop a second. Did you not do the show and not answer the phone, and you hung up after I was waiting and I changed my schedule for you? Is that true? Yes or no?
John, I had to cancel for a legitimate reason, and I told you that.
Did you do that? And I
apologize to you for that. And then I asked you.
All right, so there we go. Wait, that's what happened.
But That's not why he's mad, though. He's mad because I did a video, and he didn't like what I said in it. That's why. That's why he's
mad. Well, after you canceled his interview, though. You said
about you now. I got, and I know a lot about your life. The other guy that's on the phone knows a lot about you. I'm going to talk about you.
See what we're doing here?
Forget it. Listen.
And then you're threatening me with some random guy? What are you talking about, man?
I'm going to do what you do. I'm going to talk about your personal life. I'm going to talk about your girlfriend that left you. I'm going to talk about you getting slapped a couple times. I'm going to talk about how you got fired from Barstool. I'm going to talk about what you do. But yeah, but, I'm going to throw in about 80% of lies like you do.
The reason I asked why you were mad, like you, John, you got to admit, if anybody says the slightest thing you don't like, you kind of flip out on them.
No, I don't say it because he doesn't know me. I would flip out. Somebody's lying, of course. Are you going to like somebody? I know you got mad a couple of times, I heard, with people that said things that weren't true about you.
Of course. So
anybody with a normal brain.
What did I say that wasn't true about you?
He said,
what I don't think it was so much about a truth thing. It was so much about you canceled on him. This is the first time I'm hearing this. I don't got no sides here, Jeff. I'm your friend too.
I want to know what I said wrong to him about him. That's what I want to know. Ask him.
I'm going to tell you what. Listen. Just stop talking about me, man. Go do your own shows.
John, I'm just trying to ask you, though. What did I say to you? What did I say about you that wasn't true?
I'm telling you, stop trying to get attention off me. So you're such a bitch that if I say something, you put it out on a thing. That's like, are you kidding me? You're like a little 10-year-old kid does that.
So you can call my phone and tell me.
That you left me? Should I leave the tapes that you left me and play them?
Hey, John, you know what?
Please,
do what the fuck you gotta do, all right?
Big numbers, please.
Do it. Put what you want out, John. I don't give a fuck. Do it then. Quit fucking talking about it then. I don't give a fuck. No, you don't want to listen to me? I'm not going to listen to you.
Look at the way you talk. Listen, the only reason why you talk like that is because I'm not doing what I used to do. Because if I did what I used to do, you never open your mouth. I'll crack your fucking head open. But no, the difference is...
John, you're a rat. Shut up, John. Seriously.
Bro, you didn't...
Run the FBI.
John,
that's hostility for this guy.
Yeah, you're threatening to go after him with his personal information. Yeah.
What did he say that was so bad on his show?
Like, hold on. He said that he was taking his phone calls, recorded him, and talking about him.
Left me a voicemail, Frank. I have every right to play it. He told me to suck his dick and shit. Call me a bunch of names.
What's wrong with that?
Jesus Christ!
You weren't pissed off about it that much because you played it and you were laughing about it when you played it.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
So you weren't threatened that much about it.
Who said I was threatened?
All right, look, these guys were talking about putting a freaking interview together. You didn't do it. You were pretty. I'm not saying you were buddies, but you were cool with each other. Frank, and that's cool.
Frank, I have zero issue with John. I did a video about him. He didn't like it. He left me a crazy voicemail that I didn't understand. Ask him what I got.
Yeah, after you told him you're not going to interview, you didn't even tell him that. You said, we're not going to do the interview. And by the way, here's a fuck you. I'm going to put a video out on you.
I put the video out months later, and I was very gracious to him in it. I didn't say anything bad about him. I didn't lie. What did I lie about?
Look, I like you both. I'm not. That's all. I'm not going to say anymore.
No, Frank, I don't want Jeff to be ganged up on. You know what I mean?
He's not.
Hold on a second. I just would like to ask John before he goes or whatever he's doing. Can someone ask him in the video I did? What did I lie about?
Jeff, listen. You know you're full of shit, so I don't even get into. I'm not even going to give you attention anymore. I gave you enough attention. You got your
turn up. Sounds good. Enough. I will. You know what?
That's it. Yeah, I'm backing down. I mean, you guys got to talk about it.
I don't know, John. A lot of people have said worse shit about you over the years. I mean, I don't know. This guy didn't really seem to do anything to you to set you off. I think it's an Albanian thing, to be honest.
We're being funny. Nah. Listen,
hey, you know what's funny? He doesn't even know the slightest thing about Albania. Nothing.
See,
if
listen.
He did, he wouldn't even talk.
Well, ask him about the capital or about
Baker. I don't know about any of that. I thought this started because Jeff said that John Burke was a real killer and you disagreed.
Listen, that's laughable because you know what? Anybody would disagree. John Burke ain't no fucking killer. He's a jerk off. He might go around for a ride.
Didn't he kill Johnny Gebert?
What happened?
Didn't he kill Johnny Gebert?
Oh, here we go.
He was there. That's about it. He wasn't the shooter. So, that's, no. He was, of course, you're going to get charged with homicide. He's part of it. He ain't the shooter.
Uh-huh. Look, maybe you guys could get along one day. I don't know about tonight because it's pretty heated.
Yeah, the problem is a lot of guys talk about something, you know what they're talking about. They just read something.
John, the amount of slop on YouTube, and you're mad at me. The fucking people that say shit about you, and you're mad at me.
Talk about my other friends too, you didn't get it right. You talked about Tapita too, you didn't get nothing right that you said about him. So listen, you do a lot of, you get about 20% accurate from whoever you get the commission from, and the other 8% is bullshit.
Well, hey, thanks for watching my video.
When you're talking about these guys, and by the way, he was a legitimate tough guy.
Yep.
So when you talk about these guys, you don't even know what you're talking about.
Okay,
talk about somebody else about another murder, and you put something else on him that he didn't do.
Well, who said Tobito wasn't a tough guy?
If you're going to do what you say, you're trying to be some sort of a guy, a commentator, then at least know what you're doing. Go read some paperwork.
Okay.
You're just taking it off of some, I don't know where you're taking it off of, but you're not reading the actual papers on anything.
If you guys let me chime in a second, who knows? You both heated right now. Maybe in a couple of days, you're shutting. This will roll over, and maybe what you had planned.
I'm not heated. I got my own thing. I'm busy. I don't have time for this guy.
I'm busy.
He's got no life. So if you got nothing,
guys, spent half an hour on the phone arguing about it.
I'm talking about me. That's it.
Okay. Fair enough.
All right.
Well, listen, Jeff, let's answer this question very simply. How many months ago did I leave a message for you? How many months ago?
This was on April 25th.
Okay, so why'd you put that out just now? Because you want attention. You know what you're
doing. I didn't put anything out. Go on my YouTube channel. Do you see a fucking thing about you in the last 24 hours? No.
What do you mean the last 24 hours? What is that? You put out some tape or something of me.
John, first of all, what are you talking about? Second of all, who the fuck's the other guy on the phone? Who is that? We deserve to know.
Somebody I grew up with.
Shut up. Who the fuck are you?
That's why he's on the phone, because he grew up with you. So
he grew up with me. Then tell me who it is, tough guy.
Yeah, it could be anybody.
It's Guido Santucci.
He has no idea who I am. Who are you?
Come on, man. He knows exactly who you are.
And who is it?
Tony Pizza.
Hey, John. Hey, John, how'd you feel when you found out who MRE was?
That's a good question. John, remember the guy who used to hide behind the computer, whatever, that guy MRE.
Come on, these guys, listen, nobody who has a life acts like this. Anybody that's busy doing the right thing with their life, they don't act like this.
You're literally here.
There's something wrong with the guys that are doing this. They're like little kids. There's something wrong. You obviously don't have a life to be doing this stuff. I said, so, if you're going to do something, do just...
You're here too.
Okay? And I'm going to tell you something. Somebody that talks about a guy's child, yeah, there's something wrong with them.
Yeah.
What's there to say? And I don't know. Right back off.
Nah, nobody here ever did that. That's somebody else you're looking
for. Have you ever heard of Danny Trejo?
Not the guy, but you know what I'm saying.
What'd you say to him?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. You know that. Yeah, I got you. That's some other scumbag.
I don't know all these guys' names, and I really don't care.
Listen, John, I absolutely sent my condolences. I'm, that's devastating what happened. And,
I have to mention at the end of the show I did on it. I talked about it. John, listen, I think you think I have a beef with you. I don't. Okay. I barely done ever. I've done one show in you in my life ever. I don't know where you're so mad. What you're so mad about?
Listen, I don't bother you. Just don't bother me. That's all.
I don't bother you. I don't talk.
That's
to you.
Fair enough. These guys just stay away from each other. That's all.
He still hasn't said what I lied about. I just don't get it.
I don't know. Whatever you said, he felt was a lie.
I listened to what you did one time. I won't listen to it again. So I'm not going to go through it and take it apart because I already did it.
Okay.
You don't want to. I told you. You want to be accurate, you should have talked to Mikey Scott. You want to be accurate, you should talk to Anthony Ruggiano. You want to be accurate, I can name another 100 guys that are talking on these things you could talk to. You want to be accurate, you should have brought anyone on state. I didn't make it. He made it in open court. You want to be accurate? So you want to be accurate. Why did Ronnie want to say that he's afraid of me, that I'd kill him like everybody else if he wasn't nice to me? Why did he say that I was the partners with that family in the drug business? Why did you say that? Why didn't you say what Ronnie, why didn't you say what Mikey Scott said in all those 302s? Why didn't you say what Anthony Ruggiano said? I gotta try to think. What did you say? What happened?
I read word for word.
That he would tell you. What did you say?
Well, Jeff has a response to that.
When you're trying to say, wait, I'm going to tell you some of the things you said, actually. Now I'm thinking about it. What did you say? I had no knowledge of the Paul Castellano. Did you know that? So,
John, I don't think he did.
I don't give a fuck what you think. You're a nobody. What do I care what you think? But you know, you don't even know what you're talking about. That's the point. I don't care what you believe or don't believe. What you don't know. So what are you talking about? What you don't know? Why are you? I just asked you a question. Why did you use what Mikey Scott? It's 302. You don't got to talk to him about
that. I literally read it word for word.
Why didn't you use Ronnie Warnock's statement?
So let me ask you, John. So if I go back to the video and I cut it out and I post it on YouTube, will you believe I said it then? I literally read.
I don't. The point is.
No, you're right. You don't know. You didn't watch it.
Listen.
Get the fuck out of
here. I don't gotta watch it. Number one, if you're gonna do shows, then do it the right way. Go dig at the paperwork. Stop being a lazy bastard and go read it. Go read everybody's papers.
Here's what I'll say to you.
But if you don't read anybody's papers.
Here's what I'll say to you. I do my show the way I want to do my own fucking show. Don't tell me how to do shit. Keep out of my fucking life and I'll keep out of yours.
You became a tough guy just now. Did you eat a biscuit?
Here we go. Fucking mystery man has something to say now.
Did you just eat a biscuit, buddy?
No, it's not about being a tough guy. He's going to stand up for himself, though.
Yeah, like, I mean, come on, man.
You can stand up for yourself. What part are you going to stand up for? I just asked you a question. Did you use Ronnie Warnock's opening statement?
I literally used the exact words Michael said.
Okay, let me ask you. So let me back up for a second. Since you want to talk. When I was in prison in Brazil.
I'm not talking. You are.
Okay, just say. I said, when I was in prison in Brazil, was Ronnie Warnock, did he write on his opening statement? Yes or no? Was I in prison in Brazil when Gotti was already in with the Fed sitting down?
Yes, and I talked about how bad it was.
Was I in prison when they were all ratting? Yes or no?
And I talked about that.
Was I in prison when Johnny Burke went out to meet the government twice? He didn't go to Disneyland when he was in Citrus County. He went out.
Where's Michael?
Was I talking to anybody yet? No. They were all ratting. Every one of them. But you didn't say that. You changed the timing of everything. These guys were all talking. You didn't say shit about any of this. All these guys were talking. Greg DePalma. Fucking Fat Dom, all of them, they're all right. Joe Messina's underboss, his 12 captains. How come you didn't say that? They were all right. 54 of them against me. How come you didn't bring up all these guys' names? Because I was sitting in a penitentiary in Brazil where they were all right. 5 years later, did Johnny A. like talk? Yeah, fuck yeah, I did. And I'm not like everybody else. I didn't hide that. But why didn't you say that in your video? Why didn't you say, well, Johnny A. like was in Brazil penitentiary, they were all betraying them. They were all going to the government. All making different excuses. Why
John, I've literally led the crusade.
I didn't say that. You should have said that. And then you can call me anything you want after that. Because you know what? I'm not like everybody else. Again, I'm not like Sammy Gravano hiding in Arizona. See, when all these guys are talking killer, 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 where are they? Because I'm not hiding nowhere. See, I'm not like everybody else. So when you want to tell me about Johnny Burke, or you want to talk about Johnny Burke, he worked for me. So Johnny Burke was around since he's a kid. He went out with Anthony Ruggiano's sister since we were kids. I know the kid since he's 10 years old. I kept him around. I kept him alive. So you don't know what you're talking about. So when you talk, you better ask all the guys.
Okay.
So the problem is you're talking and you didn't get one thing accurate.
No.
And in jail, he was getting shaken down in Citrus. So, if you know guys in jail, you should find out before you talk and ask him if he went out to the prosecutor's office. So, don't tell me about stand-up guys. Don't tell me about these guys being tough guys because they're not. Don't tell me about Johnny Burke or anybody else that you don't even know what you're talking about. He didn't have 2 cents. I bought him his first house. So, now, when you want to say something, you want to act like you're a journalist and get it accurate. So if you're asking me now, you asked me, I didn't listen to it. So obviously I did listen to it.
I don't think you did because you wouldn't, I mean.
If you're going to be honest, then be honest. You should open up your thing and say, yeah, well, Johnny Bennett was sitting in a penitentiary in Brazil. All these guys were cooperating and meeting the government. All of them are rat. All of them. And then you want to call me a rat after this? Go ahead. Who am I ratting on? Because if you were married and I was fucking your wife, you don't owe your wife nothing. You understand? Or any guy. Because if she's doing that.
That's an analogy.
Well, I'm in Brazil and they're all fucking me. Yeah, of course I'm going to talk.
John, I said you were in Brazil. I talked about it.
No, you didn't. No, you didn't. No, you listen, you did not. You're spinning the story like everybody else.
Okay.
I'm not sorry about what I did.
John, I think what you're upset about is it's the first show that you weren't able to come on and hijack.
You know what prison he was in Brazil?
Who the fuck is this guy?
This guy you don't know about. This guy
who the fuck is this guy?
But you don't need to know my name. You know what prison he was in Brazil? If you talked about him in Brazil, do you know?
Shut up, you another fucking rat. Shut up.
And I'm sure he could tell you what prison. Obviously, he could.
Who are you?
You know.
Why don't you tell us who you are, and I'll tell you what prison it was.
São Paulo prison.
What prison?
Shut up, man.
São Paulo. Is that it?
No. Is
what?
Harry Fondo. You guys don't know that shit because you don't fucking report on it.
Who are you? Why don't you report on who you are, dickhead?
Yeah, I mean.
To know who I am.
Because you're a fucking. Here we go. I know. Big tough guy.
Listen, I made my points. That's it. Just stop talking.
But John, can you just say one thing? Who's this guy? Who is this guy?
It doesn't matter. You guys. This is John's voice. That's all I need to know.
No, I know. You're so. I know. We know. You're a big tough guy on the phone.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know.
All right. I'll see you guys. I got to go. I did what I said what I had to say. Just stop talking about me all good. Otherwise, what can I tell you? Just keep bullshitting around and you can spin the story all
you want. John, I've done one show on you. Okay. I don't know what else you want. There's nothing else. I haven't talked about you in months.
All right. You guys have a good night. I got to go.
All right.
Fuck you.
No cookie puss for Jeff, I guess. Yeah,
look, Casparosa was backstage, bro.
I don't think that's really him.
It's me, and you fucked up because that would have been a lot better.
Yeah, but no, but Frank hadn't come on as a guest.
You know what's happening right now? John Aylett is saying, oh my God, thank God he didn't put Chris on. That's what's happening.
Oh, yeah,
right
I'm now. Sure. I'm sure. But it was, you know, he came on here through Frank. I would have been fucking Frank over if you would have came on and started abusing him as much as it would have been.
I was just going to ask him some simple questions like, you know, what was your initial reaction when you found out I had a copy of your welfare card? What was it like when you got slapped at Sugar Daddy's? Is it true that I literally put you in the hospital from all the stress and anxiety I used to give you? Just some simple questions I want to ask him.
That would have been good.
Does he still hang out with pedophiles? You know, at what point?
Well, maybe he'll call back. Wow. John, you want to talk to Casparosa? Call back. He's got my number, obviously, because he called it. By the way, Frank, did you give my phone number to John Eli?
Without asking?
That just hit me. Like, I just changed this fucking number. Fantastic.
I got your number. Fap or Sicilian. You want to talk, Jeff?
What the fuck?
You're tough guys.
Frank, I don't know what to say about that. Let's see. He was supposed to call Jeff. I don't know, Casparosa, you got to understand, just because of Frank. You know what I mean? I'm sitting here thinking about it, and I'm like, well, Frank is the one communicating with him that had him call in. I don't want to, you know. Because I know it would have been, you know what he would have done, Chris? He would have hung up.
You know, that's why I said that in the private chat. Tell him it's a surprise guest because if you say it to me, he might just, you know, I can't hear you. My phone's cutting out. My battery's dying.
Yeah, yeah.
That's well, thank you, before. Jeff. Yo, Jeff.
I wanted to ask, you, is it true that I don't want to say who, but somebody stabbed the roof of his convertible with a steak knife?
Damn.
I don't want to say who did it. Allegedly.
Really? I'd like to know. Richie B said, no way, that was the real John Eli. Okay, sure. Yeah, it wasn't. Whatever you say.
It was an impersonator.
But Jeff, I was trying to see if I could recognize the voice of the person who was with him.
I don't know, but that was ridiculous because the dude's got a New York accent, but he's saying he grew up with Jeff. Jeff don't know who the fuck he is. And the guy knows all this about the prison.
What's crazy is nothing he said was true. I didn't get fired. Like, none of that's happened.
Everybody knows that.
Yeah, like, what is he talking about? Like,
did you get it off your chest?
what's actually funny, if funny is the right word, him talking about your employment situation is, he's not employed.
Where does he work? Exactly.
He's not employed.
Yeah.
He gets welfare.
At
least he was.
This is goes back to Desperosa up until when?
At least up until the day outside the courthouse in October 2017. When I asked him about it on camera, that he didn't know anything about that.
Yeah, sorry I cut you off, Frank. Go ahead.
Nah, you're good, man. He wanted to talk to him. This is the second time he called me. And I don't know, I guess something on Instagram. I don't even know what Instagram is because I don't go on it. I'm on Facebook, but I'm not on Instagram. And he was mad at Nadu again. I said, well, I just got off Nadu. I was on the show with you guys. I said, go on the show. He goes, I don't know how to get on. I said, call Jeff. And then he called Jeff, and he didn't get through. And then, yeah, I'm sorry, bro. I gave him your number. But it's not like I should have asked you first, but don't worry. John's not going to call you.
All right. No.
Who knows? He might come on again, so who knows?
If he wants to call back
it's good mob tube.
He's not calling back.
He's not calling back.
Like he's talking about Brazil. I literally interviewed his cellmate in Brazil. You know what I mean?
I gotta admit, everybody hated Chris more than they actually hated anybody else. Not me personally. I don't hate nobody. But when Chris was doing all this reporting, Chris was the target back then, and now nobody talks to Chris anymore.
Yeah, there was no we push back, these fucking assholes, and we push
remember
back.
Remember that, Chris?
Bring lies about me.
Hey, nobody talks to you no more, though. What's now that? You know how it feels to be me.
No, it's funny because we push back is supposed to be anti-lying informant, but these people are spreading lies about me to discredit knowingly. Not, I don't want to say all people, but a number of people knowingly just spreading lies about me to discredit me. Why? Because I denounced a Nazi? What are you fucking kidding me? A Nazi who is by every indication a confidential informant. By every indication.
Yes.
No, we know why you did that, and we know you still don't like informants. And I mean, at the end of the day, who does?
My thing is, if I'm gonna, I don't consider myself a journalist, and I don't want to be a journalist.
I think you're pretty good at it.
But I may work on a journalistic project from time to time. It's just not my thing to be like talking about other people all day long. But hey, if there's an interesting story, cool, you know. And if I'm going to interview people from whatever walk of life, I don't see it as my position to judge somebody. You know what I'm saying? It's more to tell the truth. So it's not about liking or not liking informants or anyone. It's just, well, what's the story? You know, it's not.
No, I get it. I get it. I get what you're saying, but unfortunately, it's not like that. People just, they're going to consider every informant is a lying informant, and that's the way they're going to go about it.
But that's a ridiculous assertion. I'm not saying to you.
I know it is, but that's just the way it is. Because, mob guys are not, what are they going to say? What are their families going to say all the time? They're going to be like my family is. Oh, he's lying, or he's this, or he's that. You know, that's what they do.
No, look, John Alight is a lying informant, right? But just because somebody cooperated, For somebody to say all cooperators are liars, that's basically saying all stand-up guys and every defense attorney is telling the truth. Why should you believe that? Why? Because they're doing life for 15 murders. They're a teller of the truth. You know, it's like
right.
So you don't agree that all.
No, he doesn't. No, he's not.
That's like saying all cops are good or all cops are bad. No, there's a lot of gray. Or all teachers are good teachers, or all teachers are bad teachers, or it's general. How many informants are there in the United States?
Thousands? Like saying all mobsters are innocent. You know what I mean? Nobody did anything.
No, it's. I mean, look, it's. I think I had said this to Chris, the FBS, when I first called into his show in November. I think it was. I think I said something that we kind of agreed on. That seeing how like I don't want to misquote Chris or myself, but it's there was a point in my life where I thought like some of the street guys were cool or whatever. There's nothing cool about going and doing 30 years and being away from your family. There's nothing cool about that. You know, it just, it's not a way to go. So,
yeah, let me tell you something, man. I just went to the bathroom, took a leak, and I had time to reflect on what the fuck just happened here. And that John A. Light is a real mean motherfucker, man. He's one mean motherfucker.
He John A. Light.
Well, he's in the same crew as Tony Beats or so.
John A. Light is the filth of humanity.
I consider him a friend too. So that's how I consider Jeff a friend. Gunsmoke, not so much. FPS.
Oh, yes, thanks. Basta, Frank.
Basta. I like you all. I like all you guys on the panel. You all bring good stuff to the game and everything like that. But
yeah.
I'm sorry. I mean, it had to happen. He wanted to talk to him, and I asked. And Jeff said, yeah, I'll talk to him. And they talked. And obviously, nothing came out of it. But
let me just say one thing. I just want to make this very clear. If you watch the show I did on John, I thought it was pretty fair. I didn't do anything wrong. I didn't say anything wrong. He then left me a crazy voicemail, and that's pretty much all we've talked since. He seems to think that I'm, you know, a naysayer. I don't want to believe anything he says. I thought I was pretty gracious to him, to be fair. I thought I was fair.
He doesn't just stay out of each other's lanes. That's it.
Yeah, but my whole thing was like these random people on the phone and shit. Like, who is that?
John A. That could be one of like
is that your wife, Chris?
What'd you say?
John,
is that your wife called John A. Light?
Yeah.
This
was I don't. All I know is this. Let me make this something very, very clear.
What Lee is Cole your show? Just, go ahead.
Lee Cole just jumped off the highest building.
Oh yeah, exactly.
That he could.
Yeah.
He told me like a week and a half ago. He was writing me a letter of apology for lying about me. I haven't received that letter.
Who?
Lee Cole told me that.
Yeah, don't hold your breath.
Hey, listen, FBS.
I didn't realize he was capable of writing a letter, first of all, but
FBS, if you want to make it Ratapalooza one night, I got the connections. We could do it.
Just have a whole bunch on.
Oh, that's it. Why not? If it's gonna make Lee pissed off, we could do it.
You know what? I'll say this to whoever that person was that was there with A Light. Watch your wild around him because he's looking to get you. That's what Johnny Light. Johnny Light fucks everybody. He can't help it. That's just who he is. He fucks everybody.
Probably the guy behind the rap video. Who knows? Nobody's gonna get
whoever Shiba, it is. There's a lot that I know.
I think John's humbled a lot over the death of his daughter, and you can see it in his voice when you mentioned it. Everybody was like,
"It didn't sound like."
Huh?
He sounded pretty pissed off. He said he was gonna crack his head.
But then he stopped. He's getting old. He's 60 years old, okay?
I don't listen. I'm no fan of his. You fucking know it. He knows it too. But when it comes to that, bro, I don't.
Just the way he was talking to Jeff, though, is like it shows that he hasn't changed at all. He's just the way, like, he's like, just the crazy things he's saying.
Well, that's the thing. He's an animal. That's the thing about just having him on is that Jeff wasn't calling him names. Jeff wasn't threatening him.
I never have.
But from the minute he called till the minute he hung up, he was talking shit. He was doing his usual.
I'm gonna talk about your personal life. I don't care, except I'm here for a half hour caring. Like it's weird, man. All he had to do was call me and just be like, hey, I didn't like that video. Okay, thanks. That would have it. The amount of shit people like Chris has said stuff about John. People said way worse shit than I ever did. He's
especially me.
Much about your personal life. Like, what's he even talking
about? It was bad back in the Facebook days. I was part of that. I can't believe I'm on the same panel with Castellosa. Because we heard all about it all the time.
Frank, if 8 years ago we had spoken and said, you think 8 years from now we're going to be on the screen talking about, John A. Light, and somebody on the screen asked him, what do you think about a Nazi?
Oh, no. Fuck no. No, not at all. It's kind of like comical in a way,
it's. I mean, Chris and Jeff, it's all the characters that are now Danny Trejo, all the panty sniffer, all these fucking Marlo 187, you know, threatening the fucking drive.
Marlo 187. You could have seen some
of these real years ago. They fitted perfectly. It was just one crazy lady. I can't remember if it was me or Angel, but she threatened the baseball bat. It was one of us, or maybe both of us. But it was like a 60-year-old lady, and then we found out that her daughter was in jail for murder or something, and she and this the 60-year-old lady had done porn and stuff. And I was like, what? Like, this
is crazy. And then she became a religious zealot or something, whatever.
Yeah, she was too crazy even for A-Light. Like, she was like, he had to cut her loose. At least that's the impression I got. She was too crazy for him. You know, like,
Ridge, if I'm telling you already, thank you, bro. I appreciate that. If you guys don't donate during this show, maybe I should call it a quits, because this, I mean, what better entertainment could you fucking ask for? Real. You guys should dig deep on this one.
That's why Mob 2 will never end.
Frank, we should do a show just about all these characters over the last 8 years, because, and I don't mean this as disrespect to the other three gentlemen on the screen, but it was just,
God damn it.
It's, I don't mean it like that, but it's like there was this one guy who claimed he was Gaspipe Castle's son.
Oh, remember him?
He actually looked like him and sounded like him. He looked just like him. And we were questioning. Everybody's questioning, wait, is it really his son? Like, who the fuck is this guy? Like,
you could find his videos on Michael Hollis. He had interviewed him.
That's right.
Back in the day. So you could find him. He's still there. This guy swears he was Gaspipe's son.
Yeah, but then he had like a Facebook page where he said he was like a captain in I don't know which family. At 24 years old, he was made at 19. It was just crazy.
Right, the Renzoni family.
There was another guy, like in Ohio, who was a preacher who claimed that he was a May guy in New York, whatever. But he was just like it was like Duval, Brian Duval is another lunatic. But
nah, it's just you can be whoever you want.
Jesse Roth just texted me. Is there any way you could fit more people who Angel hates on the screen? I didn't even think about it.
Lico,
she lied on her show like 2 weeks ago that I owe her $1,000 and didn't pay her. Actually, I didn't get paid from the show I did with her. I think it was like $375 a year ago when the lawsuit against Barella was filed. We did it together. We were supposed to split it. But...
Oh.
Yeah.
He's going to send 187 after you.
Yeah. Listen, Tony Ducks, $20 for donate, people. Thank you.
Nice.
Good stuff. This was a good show.
Yeah, Joey Dimes, $5 for this is great. Yeah, this was, come on, guys.
And Jeff, don't feel bad. It didn't finish that bad. This guy's kind of like,
I don't feel bad at all. I did what I had to do. I don't.
No, you're not saying anything over there. Before you were in good spirits, and now
talking to him is like talking to a fucking wall. I could do the nicest thing, and he would still find a fucking reason to bitch. Everything he said, I read the Mikey Scar statement. I did all that stuff. He didn't watch the show. He just assumed I talk shit like everybody else. And he's talking about, what did he mean by eat a biscuit? What was that about? What was up with that?
Maybe it's an Albanian thing.
That's old school. I guess that's his way of saying, did you eat your spinach today? I have no idea. But that's another thing why, you know, like, what do you mean tough guy? Like, why are you even being tough with Jeff? It's ridiculous.
It's crazy, bro. There was one person I interviewed, and I don't want to say the name on here. But there was somebody I interviewed who had lived with A-Light, and this person said that in the middle of the night, A-Light came in his room buck naked in the dark and sat on the edge of his bed and started telling him his problems, like, you know, I'm really lonely and everything. Just like, you
know, come on, man. You know,
I remember it.
It's all bullshit. I have it on video. Listen. Everybody Angel hates on this panel. I can pick four people that hate A-Light on this one, so, you know. I mean, come on. You believe he went on his bed naked?
It's on video.
I don't.
It's on video.
It's on video.
I have it on video. I'm serious.
Do you really?
Yeah, I have it on video. Somebody telling me that he sat in his bed naked in the middle of the night.
Oh, but I thought you meant you actually had the event.
Had the video of him hanging out naked.
Oh, no. It's a video of somebody telling me the story. Just like, what the fuck?
Well, I know who it is.
I don't want to say it, but...
Yeah.
Yeah, well, yeah, we know. That story's been told. Ranger Fan 11, $10 for good show. Thank you, bro. listen, and before, let me just make this clear. Before I start getting a bunch of calls and texts and a bunch of different content creators bitching about how I didn't tear John A-Light apart, listen, this was for Jeff and John to debate. If John A-Light ever wants to come on and have a real debate with me, fucking gladly.
But it also is never going to be a debate. Numerous
times, and he was cool with it, so I don't want to hear no shit from nobody.
But it's not ever going to happen. He doesn't debate. He doesn't let you speak, and then he speaks.
No, he doesn't.
If you had went with his narrative, similar to a lot of other people on YouTube, if you went with their narrative, it's they could be the best guy in the world, you know. But you question a guy like that or other people on YouTube, and no, you're persona non grata.
Right.
Yeah. What? But I can't even remember. So much was going on. What happened when he mentioned the Castellano hit? I'm so pissed off that I missed. Because I would have said that, John. I swear to you guys, I would have said John.
Mostly what he's mad about is in the video I did about him, I said that there's several things that he says that I don't actually agree that it happened. He claims that he knew about the Castellano, and I said, I don't even think Junior knew about the Castellano hit, let alone him. There's no way.
I'll never believe Junior knew about it. I'll be right back.
He said in his book, A-Light, if I remember correctly, that he went to Castellano's house like twice. I don't know, in the weeks before, like a month before or something like that. One time with John Jr. and another time with Bobby Borriello as like, and he, if I remember this correctly, and you know, he went as basically, I don't know. I think he said that the father was, John Sr. was nervous or something. And I asked John about that. And he said, he's like, if my father had brought an Albanian to Paul Castellano's house, Paul Castellano would have butchered my father in pieces. The disrespect, and a kid, no less, at like 20 years old, that you're just like, so.
Yeah, I don't believe.
And he told me, he's like, I only went there once, John Jr. He said, he's like, my father took me there when I graduated from military school. And it was like a sign of respect towards Castellano. This is my son, he just graduated. And that was the only time he went there. That's what he said.
Yeah, I mean, as you said, I think if you don't completely agree with all these people, you're persona non grata. So, whatever. You get to get a word in edgewise with him.
I'd love to hear that voicemail, though.
How about if they would have brought a Dominican to Castellano's house?
I mean, look.
No, that's a dig. That's a dig. Gun smoke.
Well, I don't know if it's appropriate to talk about it, you know.
You would have been okay because his girlfriend was Colombian.
Yeah, it's gonna say Colombian, yeah, but I don't want to. That's
you,
mistress.
You say you carry your ass out of here. I don't know. Well, how old was I when that whole Castellano thing happened? I think I was 15.
So how old was A-Light? Probably around the same age, right?
No, he's not the same age as me. He's older. He's got to be maybe 22 at that age.
I would say about 23, something like
that. Maybe 23, yeah. They're older than me.
Well, he needs some like anger management classes or something. I don't know. Something's wrong with
him. I was rooting Gotti on when I was a kid.
He's an angry guy. He's still angry at his age. I don't know. He's got to calm down.
I'll tell you what, Jeff was, you could tell, you could see in his face. I thought it was going to be kind of a screaming match, but Jeff has no patience for this motherfucker. Like, yeah. Jeff looks so worn out. Like, I'm so tired of dealing with this fucking guy.
Because he doesn't let anyone speak. Like, he doesn't have a normal conversation.
He's always been like that. Anybody who's ever interviewed him, he just talks over them, bro. He's always been like that. But the thing is, like, you know, I don't know, bro.
He has a Napoleon complex in the sense that he has to be the man. You can't outshine him. And he's one of those people. And then you add to that on top of it, he's also fucking batshit crazy, you know? So
look, I did what I had to do on him. I did a video. I thought it was fair. That's all I have on him. I'm not, you know, he can do whatever the hell it is he wants to do.
He was talking so fast. But the stuff he was saying about Brazil, he was a double agent. You know, he was fighting his case from Brazil, but also working behind the scenes, talking to, like, because he was already a confidential informant, you know, just off the books or whatever. That
this is when he was in Brazil, though.
Yeah, when he was in Brazil, he was fighting.
I thought he flipped when he came here, though. I'm not debating you enough. I'm not
He was a cooperator since 1991, at least 91, but most likely earlier. And in Brazil, he was fighting his case. He was trying to beat extradition and stay in Brazil. However, if he didn't beat extradition, he was already talking to like an agent, a retired agent behind the scenes. That was his handler in the 90s that had retired by then. That, listen, if I get extradited, well, then I'll cooperate. You know? So.
Yeah.
Also, it was made a deal in. I don't know.
I just, you know, he's never changed. He's the same fucking guy. It's like right away he's getting tough with Jeff. He's cursing him out. Like, it's stupid. When do you fucking grow up a little bit?
Maybe we all could go for drinks. Who knows?
But see, but that's how you know he's not what he claims that he was, because a real guy wouldn't act like that.
Well, let me ask you something.
Yeah.
What did you hear how he was? I remember how he was in the neighborhood growing up, you know, but this is like club stuff.
Yeah.
Nothing like, because I wasn't in the around those people that he was, and he wasn't around the people I was. But I mean, you know him to be a tough guy. You heard about it, no?
Well, look, I
know he was.
No.
Hey, I'm Frank.
A criminal.
Chris, hold on a sec. The one thing about John that he said, now, I've said many times, I've mentioned Frank, Howie have both told me John was a tough guy. I never doubted that. I never said he was anything. I'm blown away that he's this mad at me about this, because I think I've been fair to the guy personally. But
you must have done something that wounded the guy's ego. I mean, I'm not aware of what it was.
Yeah, I don't either.
And I could talk.
Sorry, Frank. I thought this all started because you said about Johnny Burke being. I mean, isn't that what it was?
He left me these voicemails. Yeah, Frank.
About an interview.
No, Frank, trust me. I did the show around the 15th of April or 20th April. He sent me a voicemail like literally 6 to 12 hours later. The show, you know, it was like 3 or 4 minutes long. And since then, I haven't heard from him. And he's been mad ever since. That interview thing happened like a year ago.
God damn
it. So you have been talking since then, that interview thing.
I thought for a while John Burke
was. I'm totally in the clouds in this, and I want to be in the clouds in this, okay? But he called me up, and I thought it was the same thing. He called me up about 3-4 months ago. It wasn't a year ago.
I thought John Burke was gonna get out of prison, you know, by now, because Alight had flip flopped on so many of his stories, and because John Alight basically said, yeah, I organized the hit that the Gebert murder that John Burke allegedly participated in, but then he's gone back and changed the story so many times. I really thought he was.
I thought John Burke is the one that pulled the trigger on Johnny Gebert, him and somebody else, right? Am I wrong?
It was Patsy Andrea. I don't remember who the trigger puller was. I don't remember the participants, but I know it was Alight. What's the other guy? Peter Zaccaro testified that he testified that Alight organized it, or they organized it together. I don't remember. And then it was Patsy Andriano, Mike Malone, and they accused John Gebert of being involved in it also. And I think, and then there was another person, David Arpino. And I think every one of those guys cooperated except for John Burke.
You said they thought they accused Johnny Gebert of being part of it. I think you messed up.
No, I'm sorry if I said that. If I said that, they accused Burke of being part of it.
He was a part of his own murder, Chris? That's gangster. Could you imagine?
He was
that's
a badass.
I heard was that, like, Alight wanted to kill him out of fear because it was just, like, he was scared of Johnny Gebert because, like, Johnny Gebert was like, no fucking, he was like a wild card. He was no joke, like a Manhattan no joke. That's what I heard. But
yeah, he was.
But Jeff, I'm gonna just go on. I'm gonna say that you got great content. You got a great show. Aside from whatever, you know, John's my friend, but his opinion on your show is not the same as mine. I just want people to know that because you have a great show, and I do deal with you, and I want you to know that.
Yeah, cool. I know. Listen, he's just
no. I don't want to play fair weather guy. I'm not. I'm gonna do it in front of everybody and not see you on the side and say, "Hey, well, your show is good" or whatever and everything. I'm sorry, these guys had this miscommunication. You know what I mean?
He just seems to think that the show that I did, he didn't like it, and that's that's
his prerogative. What do you remember what you said about it? In it that?
No, he made a comment to me in the voicemail he left me that. I don't say anything bad about the Gottis. That's what he said, which is crazy because I'm probably the one that only does.
The one that the Gotti that's on here hates you. I know that much.
Right. That's what it's so weird about it. They both hate me. But whatever. I mean, if he doesn't like it, he doesn't like it. I read the Mikey Scar statement. I read a lot of the stuff he talked about me not doing. I did. But look, just I'm not going to mention him again. I have no reason to. So, I mean, I don't know why he brought like the whole personal life shit into it. I don't know what, you know, I don't know what that was all about, but.
See, and I'm doing what I.
Well, that's why I said to him. That's why I said to him, like, why are you going to go after him his personal life? Like,
why? That's who he is.
You know, doesn't Isn't he reminding you of certain people on here? Like, you say something to hurt his feelings right away, he wants to attack your personal life, and I'm sure your family and whoever the fuck else.
Yeah. He kind of reminded me of that. Yeah, actually. I thought about that. Listen, I've heard
Johnny
this type
Light
of talk
supposed
before.
To be, yeah, Johnny yeah. Light is supposed to be like a celebrity at this point. If he thinks so little of you, Jeff Nadeau, why the fuck is he worried about it? Every little thing hurts his fucking feelings.
Yeah, he cares about what Jeff is saying about him, you know? There's like 1,000 people that talk about him.
But know? But again, he left me a voicemail and said some really fucked up shit in it, right? Like, that was... I mean, he didn't have to talk to me. Like, he's like, hey, I didn't like your video. I think you got some things wrong. He's telling me, I'll fuck you in the ass on the street. Like, he's
yeah, doing what all the fuck these
It's like, I thought it was fucked up. Like,
that's bizarre.
It's popular in Albania. I don't know.
And then he said, there's nothing wrong with me telling you to suck my dick.
No, he's a switch hitter, for real.
So, yeah.
That's nothing wrong with it.
Fucking, but you know, you're a gun smoker, right? Right now it's on the material.
Oh, no, yeah.
That's why
he's got a video done yesterday.
Oh, well, not only that, but I can already tell you what Gunsmoke's show is going to be about in the morning.
Oh, yeah, forget about it.
You should hop right on it. Yeah. Sean, I'm not sure. I'm not going to say your last name. $2 for two. Thank you very much, bro. I appreciate that.
The funniest thing that was said on this show tonight was when somebody said Lee's jumping off a building and Gunsmoke goes, ding.
I totally missed it.
You missed that? Yeah. Jeff picked up on it. I saw a little smirk there. Yeah.
I just laughed. I thought it was funny. Shit.
Well, that's listen, I come on these shows because I don't like talking to mob stuff. I do that on mob chat, whatever. This is Mob Tube. Mob Tube is fun. I have fun doing it. I think this was a good one. Could have been more funnier today, but hey, it is what it is. Yeah. And until the next one.
And I want to thank Jeff for doing that for the show. You know,
yeah.
Because that was
Jeff.
He was a good sport. Yeah.
Jeff doesn't back down from shit. You got to give it to him. You know? I was just hoping to get a more energetic Jeff, where he would just tear him to shreds.
I couldn't really. I mean, he wasn't really. It seemed like he couldn't really.
I should have given him Gunsmoke's number.
Well, it's not that he can't hear you, bro. It's that he deliberately talks over you so you can't be heard.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? No. We've seen that, you know, from him time after time, but. I don't know, man. It was good. This whole show was pretty fucking phenomenal. Guys, this is why I say, don't ever compare my show to anyone else's show. Seriously. Yeah.
Listen, you know who's going to have a field day with this pizza tomorrow?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
See all those finooks?
Bunch of rats. Yeah.
Meanwhile, Tony Pizza was probably trying to find the link so he could be part of it.
I wouldn't be surprised if not that long from now, you see A-Light calling it the Tony Pizza show.
Get the hell out of here.
If Tony Pizza is bashing everybody on here tomorrow, there's a good chance A-Light might call in and say, yeah, Tony, this is why you're a stand-up guy, because you tell the truth. Yes, I did. Yes, I did.
Yeah.
Down by the river.
Steve, yes. You know what, Steve? I know. That's why I said, you know, I don't know. You know how I feel about that, of course, and you suffered the same exact
thing 100%.
After, so yeah.
But everybody's sensitive to that too.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, but
we're not animals here.
Except for Lee.
I didn't want to say. I said that on the
Yeah, I'm not going to let that slide. But I mean, Steve, I hear you 100%. But he was always this way. You know. I understand now, though. It's got to be. You know, I'm sure he goes through pain every day. I don't know.
I'll bring up something that I came across recently. I turned on a show from, I don't know, what day in November, randomly. I think it was after I came on here, and a lot of people were very angry about it. And it was like Marla and Lee on a screen, and they were talking about me, and Marla was saying, I guess, to Angel or Angela or whoever, you know, I want to see Chris and MRE debate each other, because MRE would destroy him. And Lee was like, what are you talking about? He already destroyed him. Talking about me. And I was just like, and I'm thinking about this. This is a guy who had to bring his social worker to his bail hearing. You know what that means? That means this guy probably had a mental breakdown when they put the handcuffs on him or in the precinct or whatever. I'll tell you, like Chunk in the Goonies. I'll tell you whatever you want to know. I'll tell you anything. That's probably what happened. He probably had a mental breakdown because a social worker at a bail hearing. Have any of you ever heard of that anywhere?
Nah, bro.
Nah.
No.
Nope.
Only if Code of the Street would have gone to trial at some point. Other than that, I have no idea. I never heard of anything like that, but I don't know. Listen, so Angel said, or Lee said, I'm sorry, that MRE already crushed you in a debate.
Yeah, and I was just like,
when was that?
Say that again? I'm sorry.
When did you guys ever even debate?
No, the only I think he was, I didn't listen to, I listened to like a minute of what this was or 2 minutes of it, if that. But I think he was talking to that he destroyed me and what he said about me after I published that letter in October. I think that's what he, I don't know what he was referring to, but it's, I even, and Lee Cole is the same guy who called me like, I don't know, last May telling me that, I don't want to say what he said to me, but he was denouncing him as a Nazi and then he wasn't, you know, so.
Yeah. Well, listen, and now I think he is again. I'm not sure. You know what I mean? It's fucking, you never know. You never know what's going to happen there. Oh, shit. I don't know. What a fucking surprising show. I came on here with no plan. You know what I mean? Yeah. That's the thing about this show, all our shows. You know, it's like you don't know what's going to happen. And then boom.
That's Mob Tube.
That is. So, it's Mob Tube.
Another classic episode.
Yeah, definitely. The only thing is, you know, I was, you have no idea how I was contemplating bringing Casperosa on, just, you know, sandbagging A-Light, but it would have been, you, Frank, you see what I'm saying. It would have been disrespectful to you because you were the one communicating with him. You gave him the number to call.
I was about to, I've seen him coming up. I was like, Chris, stop.
No, what would have happened tomorrow?
Because yeah, it looks like I'm ganging up, and I'm not, you know.
Yeah. Oh, what would have happened?
But I'm not, you know, like I said, I'm partial here. I'm not here to dissect anybody's argument. I'm just if they could get together again and have a fucking interview, that's on them. I don't want nothing to do with it, you know. I thought when he called me today, it was just to say, hey, because I don't talk to him all the time, and when I do, it's like it's usually good, you know. Hey, what's up? How you doing, buddy? Everything good? Whatever. And he was heated again. And the last time I talked to him, I think he was heated. I was like, come on, man, get over it.
Yeah.
So he's been sitting with this for a while now.
Well, coincidentally, I was on with you guys. I was like, go out, just got off. He goes, well, I said, well, go on the show. He goes, I don't know how. I said, well, then call Jeff. And I think he did. I don't know. Then I left you a message underneath FBS. You didn't see it. I said, look, I'm giving him your number.
Oh, you did? Oh.
100%. You could check it too.
Yeah. I didn't see it, bro.
Yeah, because you wanted to get on, and it was I won't say sad. It was nothing sad about it, but it was stupid. That's for sure.
Yeah. Well, listen, I'm getting used to changing my number at this point, so it is what it is.
Well, that's job description at this point. No.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Yep. Steve Blair, $10 for I figured it out. Oh well, thank you, Steve. I appreciate that, man.
There you go.
Well, guys, listen. I would never end this show if I didn't have to, but this goes to show how much I love my beautiful wife. I just want to spend time with her tonight. So I want to thank all you guys for coming on. This was a fucking phenomenal show. And Jeff, you're the man, bro. Jeff could have easily been like, no, don't fucking bring him.
Yeah.
But
no, he, right. Exactly.
I figured it was going to be tough to have say much, but yeah, it was what it was.
Yeah, man. Well, you did a good job, bro. And listen, it's not you that came out looking silly. That's for goddamn sure. So, I mean, if you come on lying right off the bat and say you got fired when we know you didn't get fired,
yeah, I mean, at least get some facts straight. But thanks, John.
Yep. Chris, Gunsmoke, Frank, Jeff.
All right, guys. Thank you for having me. Have a good one, everybody.
See you, guys.
All right. Johnny, like it's food stamps. Mike Jacobs is a bitch. Peace.
Oh, I can't stand that fucking dude.
Oh, dude.
Oh, it's Mike Jacobs.
There's a lot I know about A-Light and his friends that was never published, but. Well, maybe I'll start publishing again. Who knows?
Yeah, well, fuck it. All right, man. Yeah, all right. Thanks, bro. All right. Peace. All right, guys. I would stay on forever, but it's already after midnight. I'm already mad at myself. I wanted to spend as much time as possible with my beautiful wife. But, Ranger fan, I'm sorry, bro. No problem, War. Listen, and Common Sense, poor Common Sense was trying to fucking call. You heard the beeping? That was my phone. I think he thought that A-Light was on Jeff's phone. He wanted to come on and tear him apart, you know? Thanks, Ridge. The whole show was great from beginning to end. You know, RJ came on. Mikey was in the fucking chat. Then the fucking A-Light, the Dude Showdown, which was just A-Light doing his usual and Jeff looking like he's had enough of this dude to last 10 lifetimes. Nadu is our boy no matter what. And you can't say he has no balls. You can't say he's not a good sport. So I owe him one for that, definitely. So that's it, guys. I want to appreciate you all. I'm sorry. I want to say thank you to everyone for being here. Everyone who donated, I appreciate you very much. It means a lot to me, even though... relatively speaking, I made about 10% of what I should have made on this show. But at least the people who donated were good enough to do that. So thank you, guys. Everyone else, I appreciate you as well. I will see you tomorrow at some point for Freestyle Friday. Until then, I love you all. Salute.